What chance are the Demons of repeating history? What's all? Remember round 11 last year when they were down and out but played out of their skins?
At all, Trendo!
And seized the victory over the Bombers.
Yes!
If only Mark Neal could feel the relief like Dean Bailey did.
Talk about exclamation, man!
After 9 rounds, Neal has still yet to break his duck. And the Bombers are playing like world beaters, having made a sensational start to the season.
The Big
They've taken off early before, but this time they've got the firepower and the not-so-secret weapon. Even Darce is on their bandwagon.
This is a list and a side that I genuinely feel can go all the way.
Purdy will remember round 11 last year, a bitter day for him, but a momentary triumph for the Demons.
Wonderful, Melbourne. Put it on the highlight reel.
What are the odds on a repeat? This is Saturday Night Footy. Welcome to the MCG and have a look at that banner. Even the banner is in tatters. Is Melbourne's season about to get a little bit better? Well, we're about to find out as they take on the Bombers, who are in absolutely sensational form. A late change in the Melbourne lineup tonight too, by the way. Bale is out and Morton has come in as one of the listed the emergencies there. You can see McDonald another to come in along with Sylvia as well. For the Bombers, as they make their way out, the all-conquering Bombers have simply been brilliant this year, as I welcome Luke Darcy and Matthew Richardson. They have been superb, Richo.
They certainly have. They just go from strength to strength. They've had their injuries, but it has not upset them at all. They're playing a great, balanced game of football. They've got inside talent. They've got the run on the outside. They've got a dangerous forward line, and there's not much going wrong for them at the moment.
Late change for the Bombers as well, as they bang through the banner here. You can see Job Watson looking after the young mascot there, who gets that job for a day. Hooker is out and Pears comes into the side. Cameron Ling.
So the big one I'm watching with Essendon at the moment, they've got so many good tall players, Hurley, Cramery, Tommy Bell Chambers, all these guys, but the key to it all is Paddy Ryder. He's the one who can play up forward, he can play in the ruck, he can play down back if needed. If you're too top heavy, you've got too many tall players, it can bring you undone. But with a bloke like Paddy Ryder, who's so versatile, means he can play anywhere, he can have an impact anywhere on the ground. Quality player, I'll be keeping an eye on him tonight.
Paddy Ryder, one of the absolute specials in this game out there. It is light rain out there at the moment. As I mentioned, just the one change, or the one late change in the Bombers side, and that is that Hooker has been ruled out. Pears has come in as an emergency. Fletcher, Hardingham and Jeddah making their way back into the side.
I just love the balance of this side and where it's heading. It's got a lot to like about. And Jack Watts, another big occasion for him on a Saturday night footy.
Yeah, it is, Darce. He's gone back in the last few weeks and we just saw his disposals there on screen. He's been really good at intercepting the ball, second in the AFL for the last 2 weeks, at getting the ball from the opposition and giving Melbourne a chance to go forward. He's going to have to do that tonight, Darce, in front of Cramery and Hurley down there. He needs to get across and help.
Yeah, he's a player that has had a lot of expectation placed on him.
Leave him in the back line, Richo, for the time being?
I think so. I think just leave him there for the rest of the year and let him develop and get some confidence into his game. And then maybe down the track in the next few years, you can get him to be the forward that they want him to be.
Well, Michael Hurley is someone that has a lot of excitement about him. Only playing game number 54 tonight. Hasn't really put together, you know, a great 10-game patch in his career just yet. But I think we all love the presence, the way he attacks the football, the way he demands that the ball be kicked in his direction. He's just got some aggression, some real strut about him for a young key forward. I think he's the sort of player, look, still developing, still got a long way to go, needs to get fitter, can't quite cover the ground like a key forward needs to just yet. But there is something to really build a side around Michael Hurley, particularly with the balance around him. Cramery, a great foil for him.
Always live and interactive, Darce.
Yeah, absolutely. Tonight, Richo, the tweets are coming fast and furious already.
They certainly are. We've got one from Jeff Slattery, of course, the great publisher. 21 players have kicked 14 goals or more in league footy. Lance Franklin joins 15 others today who have kicked 13. Let's hope someone can get another bag tonight.
The bounce of the ball on the other side of the break here at the G.
Tossing the coin tonight. All right, Jack, it's your call while the coin's in the air. Off you go, Zach. That's a table, mate. All right, thanks, boys.
Thanks, Zach. Good on you, mate.
Jack Trengove winning the toss and kicking to the city end of the MCG. The young man with a huge responsibility. That team there, Darce, last week, you thought and you said that you thought they could win the premiership. You still a believer?
I genuinely believe it. I think that they are as good a chance as any team going around. A long way, and Essendon fans will rightly say, hey, let's win a final first. Let's not get ahead of ourselves. But the way this list is developing, it is a very competent side. It's got great in and under midfielders. That man on screen, Joe Watson, is now a superstar of the game, in my opinion. He gets great support from Howlett and Lonigan. Stanton provides this great run around the edges. They get good speed across the defensive half of the ground as well. Runners everywhere across half back. And they've got good key forwards and good key backs, Richo. They're young, they're building, but why not this year?
Look, it's one of those years where I think any team can win it from the top eight, and this team's as good as anyone. There's the man on screen, Colin Sylvia, back into the side. So much talent, and they really need players like him to lift. Mitch Clark has been solid since coming down from Brisbane. He needs to take marks, but they need to find other options inside 50. Last week against Carlton, he was on fire early, but they went to him too often, and you can't rely on one man to kick all of your goals.
Lingy, we haven't had a lot of rain, but enough to make it a bit slippery.
Yeah, BT, very light rain, but it will be slippery. I imagine with the guys, their skills are so good these days, it won't affect them too much, but look for a little bit of slipping around early on.
You can see the radar of the rain there. Most of it has just about crossed the area we're in now. Good crowd in for this game here too at the MCG on Saturday night. Remember last time they played, round 11 last year, Melbourne defeated the Bombers by 33. They have gone in opposite direction since then, but having said that, Melbourne have won the last two here at this venue against the Bombers. Start of Saturday night footy. Bell Chambers and Jamar, two of the good ruckmen in the competition. Fletcher back into the side. Could do nothing about that opportunity. And the Demons get the first look forward as the intercept mark is taken by Kyle Hardingham. Fletcher now. Dempsey just gives him such a powerful run-off half-back. Little heavy on the ball there. Opportunity for Watts. Got clobbered in the Elwyn Davey tackle. He's been doing a lot of that sort of stuff for the Bombers. And has been the best opening to a year for that young man, Davey.
Jack Watts, started loose man in defence, which I can understand why you want to get some support earlier, but that's left Dustin Fletcher loose at the other end. The best player in the comp at doing that. You can't have that. You've got a man Fletcher up.
No, and if you let him stay loose, that is a recipe for disaster. He sets up more attacks from defensive 50 than anyone in the competition.
Hurley thought about the kick and then said, no, I want to go to Paddy, but he fell over in the contest down there with Seller, who got a reprieve. He was one of the illicit emergencies and back into the side here after initially being omitted. Opportunity here now for Job watching the skipper around the body to the punt road end, and the Bombers get the first.
Bomber fans enjoying season 2012. So is Job Watson. He will feature very prominently in Brownlow medal betting. I'm convinced of that. Great all-round player now. It's tough. He wins contested footy. And he also kicks goals.
Job Watson having an absolutely fantastic year, finishing with a great goal here. What he did was start off the back of the centre square, as he's done again here at this centre bounce. David Zaharakis is starting in the middle, pushing forward hard. Watson is then pushing himself up into the midfield.
Midfielders that can get goals, you've got to like them. All into the attack here for the Demons. Opportunity in there for Sylvia, back into the side. Dempsey was there as well. Hard nut Howlett put his head over the ball, so did the other one, Hocking. At the back door to Fletcher, who just kicks it out to the vacant southern wing. This man here, Joel McDonald, back into the lineup as well. Gave it over the top and found Daniel Nicholson. Dyson, Hocking and Watson all involved off half-back. They get it into the hands. They like to kick it from that position. Now the foot race is on here. Ryder can just flick it to Hardingham. Hardingham looking to move it forward. Missed contact with the ball in the end. And now Dan Lowe, that's a magnificent pickup by Garland.
Good to move him up forward by Mark Neal. He's given them a target already. Two touches, Colin Garland.
Grimes has kicked forward as a juggling attempt there by Trengove. Not paid by the umpire, Dempsey. Pretty scrappy old passenger play this
Melbourne
one.
Kick. Jack Trengove, straight up, thank you.
The young skipper, a lot of talk about him this season. And Hardingham does this so well. He's one of the best peel-off players in the comp.
Oh, he certainly is. Essendon have started with the seven defenders, giving them a loose man. If I was Melbourne, I wouldn't let that happen. I think they need to roll around and just play seven on seven.
Don't let it go a second pass now, Richo. Do it straight away.
Do it now. Yeah, they need to go one on one. You can't let Essendon have a loose player in defence.
They are so good with their foot skills, Richo.
They are. They're the most efficient kicking team in the comp, and they kick the ball more than anyone else, BT.
And they're playing the team in Melbourne that have more turnovers than any other team in the comp by foot.
So I think they just need to, as he has been trying to teach them, Mark Neal, is just some one-on-one footy.
Could have gone wide, Watson, elected the middle to Dempsey. He thinks about how he wanted to play on. The kick misdirected, and Watts will combine here with Sal. A bit of a no-looker over the top. Not a bad party trick from Jack, and now Nate Jones and Rivers combine. Run off half-back, the kicking skills, and that's something I just spoke about. Hocking gets a look to pump it inside 50, draws Jenner to the ball with the kick. Probably should have marked, should have given the handball as well. Didn't quite see his teammate Collier out the side door there. And that's a clear high tackle by Seller.
No!
And that's a concern for them. James Seller giving away the free kick. You know, the chip Frawley, James Frawley pulled out earlier today, and that's left Seller playing in a key defensive
clear out,
role.
Please.
The umpire there just issuing instructions.
Where are we on, Michael?
He is
right here.
A bit out of his depth, in my opinion, trying to play on Ryder and Hurley. His first kick across goal was a turnover that resulted in that, and that was just a clumsy tackle. So it's a bit of an issue already, Seller in defence.
Well, they've, of course, lost their best defender, and they've moved Garland forward, so they've probably got no other choice other than to play Seller on one of these big-name Essendon forwards.
Breezy, slippery conditions. Hurley comes in, and that one just slipped completely off the side of the boot. I don't know it's that greasy, but made a mess of it.
Live and interactive we are. Brent Redmond's texted in, wants Richo to explain why does Michael Hurley have a long sleeve on? He has had the last 3 weeks. Does he have a shoulder or arm injury, Richo?
I don't think it's an injury concern. Of course, he had the hamstring, but I just think he's been wearing that three-quarter sleeve, but gone with the long one tonight. It is chilly out there, Darce.
Richo, they're playing a game of footy. The temperature would be about 35 degrees once after about the first minute of the game. Couldn't possibly be chilly.
Well, yeah, how do
you're
you know,
kidding
Brian?
Yourself. I tell you what, a lot of old coaches, the cameraman takes a bit of a tumble there. Here's Michael Hurley with the long sleeves on. I know coaches in the past that if you decided on a wet night to put the long sleeves on, you'd want to have 40 possessions and kick five. Otherwise, you mightn't play the next week.
Just looking a little soft ass as you don the longy on.
Good evening to Robert Walls, who
yes.
I think he's just routinely dropped people.
And all those long sleeve wearers of years gone by.
Huge, huge mistake if you're playing under Wolsey to wear a long sleeve.
Belt Chambers doing the ruck work. Monfries, Lovett Murray now hocking. High ball centre half forward. Collier's under it. Off hands. Trying to keep it rolling on that occasion. McKenzie, quick soccer off the ground. I think it might have been Watson that got the toe in. Hardingham's really pushing forward early in this game. The kick to Lovett Murray out of his hands. Quick hands Hocking. Now Dempsey. Dempsey from centre half forward. Gets a chance to shape the ball and kick it long. Hurley's the danger at the back. Was there a hand in the back? Umpire said keep going. Ryder over the top of it. In the end, picked up by Nicholson. And a
in
free
the
there to Magna.
James Magna on the ball.
Great story we had on James Magna in our pre-show. Gets up at 5:30 in the morning, drives down Eastlink. Spent 2.5 years of his life building Eastlink. Likes to remind himself that that's not where he wants to end up. Prides himself on being the hardest worker at the Melbourne Football Club. Gets in there early, does ice baths. And he's been a great positive in a pretty bleak year so far, James Magna.
Sure, we'd like to say hello to all those guys still working on Eastlink that are just finishing off the odd touch or two there, Darce. But what a great reminder to drive on it every day to training. Here's Dyson, Melksham now. Little handball out the back. Monfries ran into a rather aggressive tackle. Ball won't come out of there, Richo.
I wonder if he had anything to do with that hotel that they've built on Eastlink.
The one
that you can't stay in.
Doesn't have any occupants.
Not sure we needed to spend taxpayers' money on that.
That's art, Richo. Come on, for those around Australia, a little hotel, sort of fairy hotel, isn't it? A pretend one.
People pull up alongside it and try and check in regularly.
On the edge of our freeway. That is in the name of art. There is James Magna, the man we speak of.
And they're the players that you love playing footy with, the ones that might be blessed with a lot of natural ability, Brian, that just try their absolute heart out. And Melbourne need more James Magners. They might be capable of winning tonight, but if they all give the effort that he has been giving, you can see some light.
Darcy's written them off already. I prefer to give them an opportunity here, and I think they're very much in the hunt. Their psychological advantage, having won the last two. Here is Hurley on half forward, handball inside. The little man Collier needs some clean hands, got a bit of support. He tries the Shepherd. Jack did well. Gee, Stanton, I reckon, faked it there. He'd want to be careful. And now Grimes. Handball to Nicholson. Rivers.
Well done then. They were away, Essendon. They fought well to win that back.
Coming back again, the Bombers. They belted inside again, and what's the diving mark?
That's what he's done well, Brian, the last 2 weeks. Those intercept marks in defensive 50. Just saw a great illustration there when Essendon went forward. The two guys that spread, Stanton and Collier, they just had too much spread for Melbourne on the outside moving forward.
Bring it on now, Jack. Play on!
Melbourne just possessing the ball, and that's always dangerous when you... Gee, I reckon he almost... His body was out then, Joel McDonald, but I reckon he almost kept that ball in, but... Andrew umpire says it's out. Always dangerous when you don't possess the kicking skills that other clubs do.
Saw Mark Neal go for the phone straight away. I get the feeling that that is the direct opposite to the way they want to play. That ball, I believe, should have gone down the line and safety first.
Picked up by the other McDonald. This is Tom McDonald, now Rivers. Combining there with Magna. Kick around the corner. Each possession for the Demons is under enormous pressure. Monfries just pulled the kick, saw Stanton at the very last moment there. Magna with the tackle from behind, dashing through as Collier, trying to work his way into a permanent position in this team. Hurley, was he confronted from the front unfairly by Grimes? Umpire said no. Hurley asked the question.
Seen them paid before, but he didn't look at the ball. Yeah, that was probably on.
Well, Chambers and Jamar going at it. Blessed with talented ruckman at the moment, the Bombers, and I see Hill was an emergency for this game as well, so he must be ready to play. Interesting, Darce, to get a thought from you as to where you think he might fit in, David Hill.
Well, the great news for Essendon is that David Hill, at the moment, is going to struggle to get a game. I think Bell Chambers, with the form and runs on the board, has gone past him. James Hurd will be loving the fact that there is now pressure for spots.
Holding on, Essendon free kick.
That goes against Jamar.
Ruck infringement.
There was a stage at the start of the year where Hurdy said he's going to play all three, but I think that's gone now.
I don't think that works. Yeah, I think you have to get more run into the side. So David Hill is going to have to perform very well to get back in.
Tom McDonald. Clearing kick out. Green, a timely fist, but it almost worked to the advantage of the Bombers there.
This is what Essendon have been so good at all year, just locking the ball in their forward half of the ground. They've already had 11 inside 50s to 3. Melbourne are holding up okay, but the weight of numbers and the amount of time in the Essendon forward line is eventually going to tell and end up in goals.
Good look at the setup there for this boundary throw in the forward end for the Bombers. Melksham didn't make any kick contact. McKenzie, little quick kick out. Hardingham backs in very nicely.
Mark, don't hold,
got
don't
some protection
hold.
From Pears. Might have got an accidental knock to the head there, Pears, from his teammate. Monfries. Wheels around. Cut off here.
Look, they're holding up okay, the Ds.
They have got a 50-metre penalty.
Well, that's a bonus for them because about to say their defensive structure looks okay at the moment, but at half forward, Richo, you just can't see them getting through at all. They haven't got a lead-up target.
See a good look at what he's got in front of him inside forward 50.
He wants to kick it long. No one went long, and so he eventually went to where the lead was.
If you play on Dustin Fletcher, if you don't lead to the correct position, he just won't go with you, Brian, because he's got that much experience. Yeah. He knows where if the kicker's not going to pull the trigger, and that's what he does so often.
It's a great point, Richo. He knows exactly when he's going and when he's not going. Excellent point. Here's Trengove. Around the corner, high ball. And a miss there for Trengove.
He's also Timberwork. Great, Richo, getting a matchup that he likes. Colin Sylvia is playing on him at the moment. Now, he's not going to trouble Sylvia in the one-on-one marking situation, so he just... will sift off, get in the right spots. I think they need to try and get some more heat on him.
Gee, Nicholson went at the ball then when Collier appeared to wait for it to get himself a nice bounce. Zaharakis around the corner. Seller in front of his opposite number in Ryder. Stanton
Perhaps a little hold on the legs there. Stanton now's got to be clean at ground level. Remember, a bit of rain just prior to the game starting here. That's
great
a magnificent kick. I call that the magnet kick that drew Davey to the ball. Didn't win it though. Watson, quick hands, right up. Did he have prior opportunity? Demons making sure it doesn't come out of there. He's almost been penalised.
Just talking about the Melbourne defence holding up, which they are. They've got a really good defensive shape about them when Essendon go forward. But the challenge is then, when they win the ball, you still have to run and spread and try and create something, not just stay back on your man.
Maloney threw a bit of traffic and got it nice and wide. And we find now an opportunity with Garland. Beautiful little measured kick to Howe. He goes from the boundary line with a simply magnificent kick, and he enjoys the moment.
Well, that was fantastic. Jeremy Howe against the flow, and they might have to manufacture goals and kick some from angles that are a bit like that. He's exciting, Howe, and without really genuine forward target aside from Mitch Clark, you're going to have to try and find them from another avenue, and Jeremy Howe's provided a beauty.
And this is what we're talking about here. You see the mark there, and you see Howe's spread down into that pocket. That's what you're talking about. Uncontested possession has not been hard to find for Melbourne this year. Howe pushed harder than anyone else, gets the goal.
Free kick, Essendon. High.
Hocking.
Play on.
Northern wing, beautiful kick to Watson. Into the forward pocket at the punt road end to the lead there of Cremery. And a nice extended arms mark.
You questioned Das before, BT, and NV Arts tweeted through. He absolutely agrees with Das. Only one point loss this year, and they haven't had the easiest draw, the Bombers. So I think Das is onto something. The Bombers, you should support him more, BT.
Cremery has kicked a goal in the last four games that he has played for the Bombers, and here he is looking for his first tonight offline. So he has been a danger for opposition teams up forward.
It's also been pointed out, you're not going to get dropped if you wear long sleeves if you're an Essendon player, because Jim Hurd wore it his whole career.
Good point. Absolutely. Good point, Richo. You're not calling, surely you're not calling Hurdy a little soft, are you, Das? And long sleeves.
I'm not suggesting that. I'm suggesting there were people in an era before that if that was your regular routine, no problems. But if you got a little bit of rain about, then you decided to don the long sleeve, you found yourself in a bit of trouble.
It's right up. Picked up in the end by Clark, who's come for a look on the ball. Give the big fella Jamar a rest. Garland.
He's been good, Garland. Five possessions. He's giving them a target across half forward.
Into a contest, nicely taken mark there by Daniel Nicholson. Wants to switch the play to the northern side. Melbourne looking competitive here in the early stages with 8 minutes remaining. Goal apiece. Trengove, Zaharakis just mops up what Trengove couldn't complete. Seller dropped the mark he probably should have taken in the end. And now Davey wraps the tackle up here, and that ball can't possibly come out.
It is interesting that they have chosen to play Seller down in defence, picking up Paddy Ryder initially, and they're giving Morton and Colin Garland, I should say, a run at centre-half forward. So a little bit of a change-up for Mark Neal.
Nicholson went and got it, but he really didn't want to take possession because he knew Davey was wearing him like a glove. And the moment he did, he'd be tackling him. And he did well in the end not to give away the free and just force the ball up. Right, it bangs into Clark there. Stanton around the corner. Did well to get some boot to the ball. Not the required journey. No mark will be paid there. Picked up by Monfries. Little chipper around the corner. Even the goal umpires have got the coats on tonight, Richo. So
just want to ask Lingy down there. Any midfield matchups that you're seeing at the moment, Lingy?
As normal, Heath Hocking is playing his tagging role. He's going to Brent Maloney. We know how damaging Brent Maloney can be. And vice versa, Jordy McKenzie appears to have the job on Brent Stanton. He's had a fantastic start to the season. Stanton's so damaging, it's important that McKenzie limits his influence.
So they're letting Watson roam free, as far as you can tell, Lee.
They are, Darson. Big mistake, I believe. He's already had the 11 touches.
And
Essendon lock it in their forward half again. Really great tackling pressure there from Paddy Ryder. That's what the Essendon forwards do so well. They want to lock the ball inside their forward half of the ground.
No genuine attempt there, said the umpire. I think he was right. Ryder pops at the top of the square. Hurley positions himself in front. Cramery's there as well. Melksham just tidies it up. Pulls the trigger with a handball. Cramery around the corner. I reckon it goes around the post and the umpire agrees. And a minor score there.
Salinghi, I reckon it's Joe Botson. He'd be just about the hardest guy to tag, though, because of his inside work, wouldn't he?
Yeah, Richo, this year I think he's definitely added, he's added that outside damaging part to his game, which makes him even harder to stop. Previously he was just inside, but now he's got both. It's so hard to stop those players.
It's on here for the Bombers. Get out of the way. Dempsey, Stanton wanted to have a crack. Well smothered, Jones. Brilliant stuff. They'll get another look. Big Essendon numbers around this, please. Who is fleet of foot. It's a second look at it. The back to Seller and now Green. So, Lingy, when you come to the football, you get great pleasure out of watching taggers. I mean, that'd be a pretty boring thing, wouldn't it, coming to watch a tagger? Is that? I mean, I come to watch the forwards and the midfielders. You come to watch the taggers.
Not necessarily the taggers, BT. I love a good matchup in the middle of the ground and watching two blokes sort each other out and see who gets on top at the end of the day.
Collier, beautiful to Hurley on the lead.
BT, we all know how important taggers are for the game.
Come on, Lingy.
Here's young Sam Blues, BT, who just tried to bite off a little more than he could chew and probably needed to drive that one 80 metres away from goal. Instead, turned over.
Now, look at that. Hurley stepped outside. If I were the umpire, I would have called play on. Tried to sneak a bit of angle off him, about a half a degree. Tough kick this. Wet ball needs to be dropped perfectly. Good connection required from hand to foot. And you can see what happens if that doesn't happen.
Just stabbed at his first two set shots tonight. Hasn't really kicked through them at all.
Tapp's got with the kick-in duties.
Jordan McKenzie actually got the three Brownlow votes last time these teams played, Brian.
Jordy McKenzie?
Yep.
Yeah. 33-point win to the Ds. That was in round 11 last year. Lees goes in, comes out with the without the ball. Mumfries thought about the left footer. Dyson, who played very well last week against GWS. Lees bangs it forward. Here he is, Mr. Anchorman. Fletcher. Game 368 for Dustin Fletcher. Howlett now wide. Sends it long and deep. Got the support down there of Jack Watts.
The old-fashioned flood going at the moment, the Demons. It's been in Essendon's forward half of the ground. 73% of the quarter so far. We've only got 4 minutes 38 remaining.
Sure.
They have just flooded back. And the problem is that shot you're seeing there, they just don't look like getting it past the halfway mark of the ground. So they've kept the score even. Maybe that's their plan. See if we can at least not get blown away in the first quarter. But they can't keep it up for too long. Sheer weight of numbers will get them.
Carlisle here, battling for the ball at ground level. He and Jake Melksham played together at the Calder Cannons, of course. Howe around the corner, but look who's back there. Look who reads it better than anyone else.
It was just like the wicketkeeper then. We saw him do it earlier this year when he was so good in that game up at Metricon against the Gold Coast. He will just sit back, and if you let him, he'll do that all day long, Dustin.
I think I said game 368. Game 356 tonight. He will play game 368 if he plays every game between now and round 23. Dustin Fletcher. 368 games come the end of the year after round 23. And still going with plenty to give as well. Lees threw a bit of traffic on the left. Thought of the centering ball, no Melbourne player there.
We saw how wide Mitch Clark had to lead then. He had to lead out to the point of the boundary and the 50. That was because Dustin Fletcher is sitting 30 metres out and where he's going to get the ball here now. And if they do that, they'll have to go wide all night. It's going to be so tough to score goals.
Got loose men every time they turn left or right here, the Bombers. And that's all out of what Richo's explaining, that loose man of defence. They are so good at spreading and exposing the loose man. Here's Howlett at half forward. Nicely nursed kick. Ryder couldn't quite get there. Rivers chips in and sees something on the north side. Good ball to Garland. Got Maloney short, ignored that. Now has to go to Magna. Ball didn't get to him.
It's just
you're almost counting the numbers there, Mark Neal. Did you see that? They have gone in with a tactic tonight, just I think to try and get this game as close as they can at quarter time, and that is with a heap of numbers back. We'll see them they go forward, that Fletcher, Hardingham, they're all queued up at the other end of the ground as well.
Interesting shot. That's exactly what he was doing, Darce, I reckon. Here's Jamar. Big leap there from Belk Chambers, I think it might have been. Melbourne, some numbers in the pocket. Rivers can only kick it around the corner. He did well.
And let's be honest, Richo, all things equal tonight, Melbourne just aren't good enough on current form to get anywhere near the Bombers. So if Mark Neild has decided to come in and try and change things up to make this a contest and then just see if the mental pressure gets to Essendon, well, I reckon that's fair enough.
Don't agree with you, Darce. I reckon they aren't capable of being competitive and can get the Bombers to three-quarter time and not too far off the pace.
Well, that would be the tactic, and then you hope that they get the sniff come the last quarter.
Amazing things happen with scoreboard pressure, Richo. Amazing things. Here's Tapscott and Davey.
Well, that's exactly what I'm saying, BT. As they get a 50 here, Alan Davey, James Hurd just hooks up and not overly happy with the way this first quarter's unfold. I'm saying if they went for a shootout, went player for player and tried to beat the Bombers conventionally.
Try and cover it up. You're being very negative towards the Demons, and they wouldn't appreciate
words,
it.
Brian, because I'm suggesting that Mark Neild is doing something different, which he hasn't done before, and that is to get a lot of numbers in defence to try and do exactly what you said. Get inside their head, and then they can maybe pull off the miracle win.
Sam Blee's got a knee to the head almost, and a free kick, and rightly so.
Well, one thing they are doing is this, and Blee's put his head over the football there. They're level on contested possession, so they've got a few things right so far tonight.
Soren coming off is Blee's. In the meantime, the ball goes forward. Jamar got a couple of hands on it. Silvery around the corner. Did he bend it enough? Not quite.
Both defences have taken seven marks off the opposition boot in their own defensive 50. So that just sums up the loose man at each end.
Dr. Peter Larkins, we welcome you. Blees with a little knock there.
Yeah, good evening, Brian. Yeah, he did. He put his head over the ball, got a free kick and came off sore. He's just on the bench having a chat, limping on the left side. They're going to check him.
All right, keep an eye on it, Doc. Here's Howlett. Put down the tackle. Little umpire said didn't have it.
Didn't take possession, Brad.
Didn't take possession.
Never had possession.
Says umpire Steve McBurney, one of the most experienced in the business. That is Blees, the lower half of him anyway. Howlett goes wide without great direction. Hurley. John McDonald couldn't put a stop to that. Lovett Murray, the little drawing handball over the top to Melksham, who's just improving week by week. Gets to Ryder, stuck it to his advantage. But the assisting player there to assist Tom McDonald was excellent.
The black armbands tonight, you're seeing Paddy Ryder there for 1946 Premiership player George Hassell.
Premiership player and life member, of course, Darce for the Bombers. Belk Chambers around the corner. Ryder a juggling mark, will be paid in the end.
Clear out, right out five.
See if he plays on from here. Melksham says go for the drop punt. I think Paddy's saying to Melksham, get out of the way, that's where I want to run around. Have a look at this. A really good look at what confronts a modern day player from here. They don't like the drop punt kick, generally. And there it is. Turn around, kick around the corner. They are very good at it. Not this time.
Just got it a little bit on the fat side of the ball. Didn't get it to turn enough.
What is it, Richo? Is it the feel of the ball under the boot around the corner that you feel you've got more control?
Well, it could be for a player like Ryder. I've got no idea how it feels on the boot, to be honest, Brian.
Well, I think in a slippery conditions...
Oh, Richo. You kicked 880 goals.
Actually hit them all right. The man alongside of me, Big Richo. You watch Stevie J when they line up on a windy day. When you drop it across your body, there's less margin for error than a straight drop with it blowing out of your hand, Richo. I think that might tells be us, where they're going.
Tells us he had a better kicking ratio than Super Boot Bernie Quinlan, Richo.
That's actually correct.
Oh. Well, here at quarter time, it is a slow scoring affair, and that will be just what the doctor ordered for the Demons. They are in the hunt. Three down. Darce doesn't give them a chance. I give them a big chance. Melbourne 1-2-8. The Bombers 1-5-11.
low-scoring affair here at the MCG in the first quarter. The Bombers lead it by 3 points over the Demons. 1-5-11 to Melbourne, 1-2-8. Cameron Ling is down there with Mark Neal. Take it away, Lingy.
Neal, very even in the contested ball in that first quarter. Must be happy with the crack the boys are having at the contest.
Yeah, Lingy, we are. We thought we were having a good crack at the contest. We just the Bombers just pulled apart our forward structure. We're a bit disappointed with that. The boys kicking into a forward line, being outnumbered. We're going to have to work on that. But the boys having a crack.
Inside 50s, 20-9. How do you even that up?
Well, we've got to keep a structure forward of the ball, so we've got someone to actually kick the ball too. That'll help.
Well, thanks for your time, mate. All the best.
Seems reasonably happy there. And Mark, do you have some vision here at three-quarter time with the two senior boys going at it?
Yeah, I don't think Bomber and Hurdy were overly impressed with perhaps the attitude and the way that they handled the first term. It was interesting to hear Mark Neal then say, we want to try and maintain more of a forward structure, which sort of contradicts what we're thinking, that they are indeed trying to flood back.
That footage there of Mark Thompson, almost coaching James Hurd, wasn't he? Explaining the overall big picture to him.
Seems to work perfectly,
yeah,
doesn't
it?
They've got a great relationship, the two of them. They won a premiership together. They know each other well. Been a great value from the outside looking in for James Hurd to have that experience around him.
Certainly has been. And Melbourne have held the Bombers to their second lowest scoring quarter for the season. So the tactic of getting that man back has kept the Bombers down, and it's giving them a good chance to stay in this contest.
The other low score quarter for the Bombers was against the Pies,
against Collingwood.
And this is where they're actually getting a bit of an advantage, is in the clearance situation. They won it in the first quarter. Mark Jamar getting his hands to the ball. Last year, his combination with Maloney was just unbelievable.
Kick out wide to that man, Maloney. The weather looks to have cleared a little bit, Lingy.
It has been, no rain at the moment, but it'll continue being slippery right throughout the night. I think it'll just have light showers throughout the evening.
That was great from Maloney. He spread out of that free kick from the centre corridor, and Ryder did well to actually cover him and go and force the contest there.
Doing all right here, the Demons, at the moment. Jones threw a bit of traffic, zigzag, got him in the end, Jetta.
Saw a couple of those not paid last night. It's good to see them paying correct holding the ball decisions.
Well, he didn't handball, he didn't kick it. I mean, you could say it was knocked out on the tackle, but he had prior opportunity, Richard.
I have seen those being called play on this year when the ball just falls out and they let it go. It'll reward the tackler. That's what the rules of the game committee were looking at, I reckon.
Richo all over the rules. I think he wants a spot on that committee, Darce. I think he's going, I can get that job done.
The people's person.
Yeah. He's just really trying to cut someone's lunch in the rules committee there. I'm not sure who. Collier around the corner. Demons again. Some numbers in defence. Little shortage on the handball. Fast to Maloney to Jones. Doing a nice job here in tight, the Demons. Not pretty looking. Here is McDonald back into the side. Of course, Joel McDonald. Jamar scrapping for the ball at ground level is a great sign for his team. Fighting like anything. McKenzie in amongst it as well. Now Jack Watts. Done a good job early. Beautiful spin out of the tackle there from Hurley. Now Jetta, fleet of foot. Tried to sell a little bit of foot candy then. Got himself into some trouble, but he's won a three.
Yeah, unlucky. The pressure was good there. Just fell into his back at the last minute, young McDonald.
Sloppy handball to Hurley, but he didn't panic. Hurley gets a look at it. Belt Chambers at the top. Both hands on it. Second grab, couldn't get it. Davey was almost through at the same time. Fast hands by Joel McDonald. Rivers now keeps it moving forward.
Tackled him, free kick. Melbourne.
Well done, Jared Rivers.
Tackled him, didn't take possession, Alwyn. Mind play on.
Just explaining to Alwyn Davey why he paid that kick. Like to see that from the umpires. Trent Gove.
This is where they've struggled to get through. And Sylvia is their lead-up target at the moment. Fletcher has him covered.
Garland need to think their way through carefully. Fletcher getting back, but at least he's manned up. Mitch Clark offhand, so that's why the mark wasn't paid. Handball back to Magna. Picked up by Blease. Just couldn't get it on the left. Dempsey.
And Blease had to try and kick that cute ball around his body because that man there was standing in the exact spot where Blease wanted to kick it. He forces midfielders into kicks they can't kick and they turn it over.
Colin Sylvia was in an unrealistic position. He was standing 40 metres out. Blease couldn't get it to him. He would have been better off bolting to the goal square and getting Fletcher to man him up.
Somehow that ball stayed in when everyone thought it was going to go out. And 50 against Green here.
Yeah, and that was there, BT, because absolutely tried to hold up play there, Brad Green. Should know better than that. As soon as you grab hold of the player after Let's have a look at this. Dyson going back. You can't hold on to the jumper and restrict his momentum 50 metres.
Ricky Dyson, the recipient.
It does seem harsh, but players should know by now.
Splitting hairs there, I think. But anyway.
Yeah, I agree with you, Brian, but it's been there for a while and you just need to adjust.
Well, I know you're going for the rules committee, Richie. You don't have to make it obvious as Dyson sprays it to the left.
A lot of people ask why we pump Michael Hurley up so much. It's a wet ball. For a key forward to be able to attack it with that sort of pace, pirouette and spin in the one move, that's the glimpse of a star. Not able to do it for four quarters. When he does, eventually he may be one of the better forwards in the game.
He just needs to get a good run at it, doesn't he, without injury for 2 or 3 months. And I reckon that breakout game would come with that.
Brad Green read that brilliantly. Knew it was always going to come off the pack long in the slippery conditions. Kept it rolling. They work it to the wing here now. Green again involved. Really nice play from the Demons. Can they keep control now by foot? Comes back in the Green direction. Dempsey, a lunging tackle. That was simply superb. Dyson back into the middle. Don't know how he saw Watson. I reckon it was a deliberate kick. Now Watson, just a little chipper. Trying to draw Bell Chambers to the ball. He didn't come. Sellers spins out of the potential tackle.
So this is good by Jack Watts. If you're the loose man, you need to get involved on the way out. And he's done well there.
Grimes. Just a little chipper. Back inside to Morton. The late replacement, Morton. To the side. James Frawley out.
It's good to see Mark Neal, BT, hasn't been stubborn enough to not change. When he came in, he said, I'm going to play Jack Watts forward. That's what he's recruited for. There will be no change to that. People said he should have a run in defence. Well, it hadn't worked for Jack Watts. He's now decided that is his role, and I think I'm warming to the fact that that might be where he needs to develop.
Dyson. In the corner, Bombers line up. Bell Chambers again, fumbling and fiddling and faddling at ground level. In goes Watts, kept it rolling. Umpires pinged him for a throw.
Play stopped.
Just thought they'd have another look at that one. A bit of a knock-on, I reckon, Richo, but
umpire was close. Zaharakis decides to go. No one on the mark. A little lazy there. Kick forward. Caught in the middle of Cramery. Grimes. Watts getting plenty of the ball.
Possession number 12, BT. That one for Jack Watts, leading possession gatherer for the Demons.
There's Magna, Mr. Eastlink himself.
That was great. Nicholson then dropped back and got a heavy knock that chopped off the Essendon forward.
Speaking about Mark Neal, BT, also not being stubborn enough to change. I think that's what's happening tonight. Oh, I don't know whether you need to take Michael Hurley on there.
Tom McDonald made a bit of a mess of that. Collier comes in, tries to ram it home. Not successful.
James Hurd would absolutely love that from Michael Hurley. That's what you want your big key star forwards to be able to do as well. It's not just up to the little blokes. Lay the tackles, trap the ball in your forward 50. Well done, Michael Hurley.
Yeah, great effort, Lee. I think tonight Mark Neal has changed. I reckon when he came into the job, he said, I'm going to teach them to play the footy the way I want them to play, regardless of the scoreboard. Well, I think he's decided 100-point losses just destroy the whole fabric of the club. So tonight he's set up just to compete, and so far they are.
Melksham to the top of the square. Demons get some numbers back here. Mark paid to Jack Watts.
This is why Jack Watts will be a good player. He reads the play so well. Once he gets some confidence up and the Melbourne team gets up playing some good footy.
Tweet here from Benny Wise. Very happy to see Ricky Dyson back in the Bombers side. He's very underrated, says Ben. We agree. Played a really good game last week. Weaker opposition, we know. Maloney inside. Finds a patient Morton.
Well, that was a great passage of play. Jack Watts won the ball back inside defensive 50 goal square, and they really spread hard forward. And Carl Moore, he can do that. He's got a great tank, but it started with that man there reading the play and setting them up. And
that mark wasn't paid. It was a free kick that was paid there. And if you're thinking the mark was a little dubious, this is the result at the other end of the ground. Morton having a bit of a look from 35 out, almost directly in front. He's got every bit of it. And guess what? What about this for the Demons?
Oh, we're in front, Richard, by a point. And they just start building a bit of a psychological case. Have we turned up with the correct attitude, Essendon? And that's what it's all about. Low scoring, seeing if you can get the side that hasn't come with 100% intensity and pull off a miracle win. Maybe.
Well, stranger things have happened, Darcy. You didn't quite get this in the first quarter. The Demons lead it by a point. They're playing nice, controlled footy. And I personally am a fan of what they're doing right here at this moment. Can they maintain it? The Bombers. Watson looking for Zaharakis, please. Wanted it back too. You've got to like that. Grimes to Green. It's wide. Swings on his left. Keeps it alive. Back in the danger zone. Here they come now. Sylvia probably spoiled his own man then. Went without it. Magna. Howlett and Morton go at it. Quick hands to Jamar. Had to get rid of it. He did. McKenzie almost a throw. Tapscott clever. Knew he couldn't take possession. Wonderful play by Tapscott. Here's Joel McDonald. Did what he had to do, but the beneficiary is Dempsey. Through the hands of Crammery. Just starting to get a little shaky. Now Lovett Murray. The inside runner is Jeddah. The 1-2. Watts corrals rather than go at him. Well done. Forced the turnover through pure pressure in the end, the Demons. That is good play.
That's spot on, BT. That was great pressure. They looked like they were out. The Bombers running forward. Jack Watson.
Jumping punches going on there.
He can throw a good punch. Like Murray.
Yeah, and look at James Hurd. Take the cans off. He's got some worry now, James Hurd. He's thinking his side just are off the boil a little bit. Ill discipline back there from Ricky Dyson. That his temper get the better of him.
Just have a look at the... If we get an opportunity, but James Hurd at the moment, just the little jumper punches here. There was one there that missed the right cross around the back. Lucky he missed with that, Lovett Murray.
That's just not smart. You're not going to get anywhere apart from suspended if you start throwing a couple of cheap rights.
Morton tries to bore a hole through anyone in front of him. Here is Dyson. Watson unsure what to do. Magna back to the favoured left boot of Dyson. Went down. Was it Tapscott there? Looked like him. Got a bit of a clip. It was. He's tough. Jeddah. Trying to say that he was got high. It was feeding him around the belly button. Jones. Dyson ran straight at it. Now Stanton's got to go. Here's Crammery. Gives it to Monfries. The pressure from behind was good and forced the turnover. Jeddah still down behind play. Seller. So just getting it done at the moment. You wonder how long the Demons can maintain this sort of pressure. That's the key. Clark, handball to himself. Not bad for a big man. He advanced the ball, and in the end, that's a bit of a win as Jeddah behind
play.
Well,
let's take a look at Jeddah, because he was reprimanded for diving a couple of weeks ago. Now, he's had a shocker there.
Oh.
He got tackled around the waist. Threw his head back searching for a free kick. He's been given a little warning for diving.
Yep.
Well, they might have to follow through with a bit of a fine because it's starting to creep in a little bit, Richo. He might have caught one low, but the head throw back. You're trying to suck the umpire into a free kick. That's not the way we play our game.
Look, it's an instinctive reaction from him, but it's not a good one.
Boys, the boundary umpire here has paid this one for in the back. He's overruled the field umpire and paid that one in the back.
And, of course, as you rightly point out, Lingy, the boundary umpires are out to do that these days, correct?
They are, but I'm not sure that one was there, boys. I'm not sure I agree with him.
But they are allowed to be involved in that free kick process these days, aren't they?
I don't.
No?
I'm not sure where that rule came in, Brian.
It was trialled.
It was out on the full in the end, we've been told anyway.
I apologise, boys. My mistake.
It's all right, Lingy. You make the occasional one. You won a few premierships, so we forgive you.
They looked at it in the NAB Cup, though. The boundary. They could only pay them, though, at the stoppages.
Just got ratified by BT, though. He gave them all clear to start paying them.
I've been sitting alongside the new rules committee member, Matthew Richardson, and that's what he sneakily told me on the side would probably happen, and I got confused. Here's Lovett Murray. Richo, you're odds on to get that job. Please. Around the corner, he's been dying to get on a committee since he retired. Here is Maloney, gathers the ball, just intelligently puts it at the square, knowing it'll spin off the ground. And it does exactly that. The Demons with three goals in a row.
Bit of excitement for the Demon fans. I think they've won too many quarters or been in front too often at all. In 2012, just five quarters they have won Melbourne this season, which is unbelievable. They find themselves with a nice little 7-point lead.
Only four goals kicked in the game, but the Demons have kicked the last three. Maloney knew this, Richo, would skid once it hit the deck.
That's just experience. He summed that up perfectly. Didn't try and overkick the ball. We had an open goal square, and in the wet conditions, it always goes straight on. Very well done.
Now, you just get the feeling the Bombers might get a little anxious here.
It's actually one-on-one all over the ground now, too, BT.
Gee, I tell you what, McKenzie, well, I think it was McKenzie in hard then, injured Hocking. Such his ferocity at the ball. In the corner, did well to back in then Maloney against Lovett Murray. Now Jetter in the middle of the ground. Gets a bit of clear ball, but mungers it forward. Cramery would have given away the free for sure. So Melbourne at the moment, absolutely rock solid. McDonald, that's Joel. Bangs it out to Green and Hardingham. Just read it better, Green. Goes on immediately. High ball in they go. They queue up at the back, Sylvia. Nicely done, Fletcher.
Clear out.
Against Sylvia.
Well, see, the Demons have only won five quarters this season. Nine rounds in is just a staggering statistic. They're getting some real momentum in this game at the moment, starting to build some confidence.
What about this? The one-handed pickup from Jones. The right foot banana. Remarkable goal from Jones. Great pressure. Oh, boy.
Look at the Melbourne fans. Haven't had anything to get excited about.
There's a short sleeve jumper.
No long sleeve required for that man. He's as hard as they come.
Well, he's up and about. He's excited. He doesn't need the long sleeve.
Harold's too old to wear a footy jumper.
It really is amazing when a young team who hasn't had a win on the board gets a sniff of confidence. When they're allowed to play, things start working, things start happening for them. They get their tails up and away they go.
Oh, Lingy, we spoke about this in the first quarter, didn't we? Now the opportunity for the Bombers to respond in the middle. They've got a great midfield unit.
He was on his feet when tackled, no chance.
And Nathan Jones enjoying every moment of it, gliding almost in thin air there.
And it's when you've been as up as Essendon have been for 9 weeks, it's impossible to keep up for the whole year.
Stanton with a clearance. Goes forward and finds Cramery, the first real good bit of clean centre clearance work.
And Jared Rivers can't believe it. He was doing the right thing, protecting the space where the ball should go. This is an out of outstep torque that just falls exactly in Cramery's lap. The defender, you just can't believe that.
Cramery lines up to try and ignite the Bombers here. They can score quickly, and that would be very much in the minds of the Melbourne players, and just not getting it right at the moment. Jared Rivers probably will need a new jumper at some stage.
Well, Melbourne are last in the comp for disposals per game, with just over 300, but they're winning the count tonight. 164 to 159. I doubt they would have led a possession count at halftime this year, especially against a team like the Bombers, who have been in control of that all season.
Third man up, Ryder over the back. Howlett was ready for the take. Joel McDonald goes in for the Demons and just hustles the ball out into a bit of neutral wing territory. Hardingham caught under this. Green helped it forward, but Fletcher. D's would be happy with that. Now they get a chance to get into a scoring position. Here.
Joe Watson's died out of the game in this second quarter. Lingy, who's been doing the job there?
If I had to guess, Richo, I'm not 100% sure. I reckon it's Jack Grimes has pushed up and doing the job, which is great by him. Great leadership to go and play on a quality player like Joe Watson.
Sylvia, front centre was Green.
Much better movement patterns there for Colin Sylvia to keep an eye on Joe Watson. I think he's just had the four disposals this quarter. And we just saw Sylvia work really hard back and then get Fletcher in a position where he had to defend him. And that's what he's got to do.
Quite right. Grimes there getting the job on Watson. This stoppage. So Melbourne have now got it in a really good position at their end of the ground. You see Grimes and Watson there. Stoppage all about the drop zone of the ball and covering that off and creating more space for the attacking team. In went Blees, backed out quickly. Lovett Murray. Blees with the head over the ball. Need to knock it out. He'll be pinged here. Scrappy stuff.
Mark Neal spoke about it at quarter time, boys, about the fact they needed to get even numbers forward of the footy. Couldn't have Dustin Fletcher and the Essendon players loose behind. They've done it a lot better this quarter. Every time it goes forward, it's to even number contests.
Measuring every second, Mark Neal in the box and explaining to those in the box exactly what he likes. Morton allowed McDonald to pick up the ball from one McDonald to another. Tom was the kicker and he found Melksham.
Paul's just asked on the Twitter as Melksham's kit's turned over.
Mark Jamar dropped out there. He's handballed it off to Maloney.
Maloney goes to the top of square. Green elevates, couldn't hold the mark. Off hands, picked up by Howe. Didn't get enough boot on it. Carlisle just sends it tumbling back towards the half-back line for the Bombers. Make no mistake, they're under real pressure. Joel McDonald carried forward in the tackle. The Demons applying the pressure.
Yeah, just getting back to the tweet from Paul, wants to know and ask Richo, thinks he's after KB's spot on the Rules Committee. If you get in, Richo, will you scrap the hands in the back rule when you get the job on the Rules Committee? Not one you liked as a player.
Yeah, no, I'd probably bring that back in and jump all over anyone's back if you're trying to mark the football.
A chairman, I think, the chairmanship of that committee becoming available too for Richo. So,
and you'll be able to show a bit of emotion when a stinking decision happens as well.
And attacking the ball was Garland, got it off to Mitch Clark. Left foot around the body to the punt road end. I tell you what, just missed.
The interesting thing in the game is, from an Essendon point of view, they'll be looking forward to half time to just sit down. I reckon it's almost one of those ones where James Hurd just grabs hold of a couple and suggests that their attitude and the way they've approached this game hasn't been anywhere near the level that they've brought to the first nine rounds. It's always a difficult thing to switch on. They'll need to.
3-1-3 behinds in favour of the Demon in this second quarter. Pears has got one over the top here. Jamar looked rather tired there. Couldn't get back. Pears did well to shrug the tackle. His kick was partially smothered, as you can see. And in the end, the boundary line of winner.
Oh, I love the effort of that man there, Daniel Nicholson. He came across. And look at the teammates. How about the body language of Melbourne players again at the moment? He ran 50 metres for the smother, got back up, forced it out of bounds.
They're up. Make no mistake about it. Taps got Watson. Non-freeze goes in, but this will be balled up. It's a quietish G at the moment. Good crowd in considering the conditions here. MCG, bleak sort of night, not a lot of rain, bit of rain, but rather cool. Tapscott. The clearance, Lovett Murray with the strength. Magna equal to the task there. Knocked in the path of Maloney. Looked for a runner. There was nothing on, so he went back searching for one. Eventually found Rivers. This is a good forward thrust here. Grimes will be the recipient. Looked to go inside. Good kick to Clark. Did it get there? He claims it, and the umpire agrees.
Right here.
So this is within reach.
In the box seat there. They can't believe it. It looked like a half volley, my initial thoughts, but the umpire in the best spot. That's...
Oh, no.
No, I reckon he got the hands
got
under it. I reckon it's bounced off the hands which are on the ground.
Bounced off his forearm, I reckon.
Let's have a look.
Yeah, he got under that.
Got under it.
Good decision.
Great decision from the umpire. He was right there, as you can see. There he is. Got a perfect look at it. And it did look like it was a bump ball, but off his fingers under the ball. Mitch Clark, a really difficult kick. And that will not be a goal.
Well, Mitch Clark's been the man this year, hasn't he? He's kicked 20 goals. Their next leading goal scorer, Nathan Jones, with 10. They've relied so much on him tonight. The good thing is that he really hasn't been sighted. But they've been getting a good lift from a lot of their players who haven't really figured it all this year.
Very much a workmanlike performance at the moment from the Demons. Can't hang on there. Rivers got himself in a position he didn't want to be. Now Monfries. It's a 2-on-1 further down the field. He wanted to try and avoid that, and he did it well. Bring it back into the corridor. Zarakis is there. Cramery spun out of the tackle. Zarakis back to Davey. What can he do? Got great evasive skills. Coughed it up. Trengove. Melksham almost infringed. Fell forward in the tackle there, Davey. Rivers grinding it out underneath. The Demons will not give up. Eventually, Melksham goes and get it. He's not making a genuine attempt, surely.
Well,
Jake Melksham.
You cannot doubt the effort at all from Melbourne tonight. Mark Neal will be wrapped at half-time. They're really having a crack, and they're starting to get a little bit of belief out of it.
3:16 remaining in the half, Richo.
Stanton, danger here for the Demons. Now starting to apply some tackles, the Bombers. Clearance to the middle of the ground to Sylvia. Got the chest mark, thought about the handball. Probably should have given it. I don't know why he didn't. Goes long to Clark, who's outside 50. Beautiful gather by the big man against Carlisle. Back into Garland. Little clumsy below his knees. So he says, you have a go, Maloney. And he does.
She had it. Had a little bit more time than Maloney than he thought he did. Could have just snapped around the corner. Could have taken a little bit more time then.
Could have almost been 50 against Mitch Clark then. Touched the player after he completed the mark. A long time after he completed the mark too, I might add. Stanton now. Beautiful ball. Monfries trying to take it on the chest. Watt scrapping it out. The support from Magna arrived, but got him high. Angus Monfries.
Let him have it. He doesn't have to give it to you.
Well, you give it to him, umpire.
Why can't the umpire throw it to him?
Oh, he didn't want to bend over, Richo. Just throw it back. Monfries. Hurley elevates. So did Bell Chambers. Ryder's got it going towards goal. Soccer off the ground here from Davies on the go. The Bombers get their first goal of the second quarter with under two remaining.
Always going to be good luck catching Alan Davey once he had some daylight running towards goal. No one in the league can catch that man, Richo, with that sort of leg speed.
Once he gets goal side and he gets a bit of grass between him and the goals, you're no way known you're going to catch him. He's had such a good year. He's turned his career around in the first 9 weeks of this season. His pressure's been great, hitting the scoreboard as well.
No catching this little man when he gets goal side of you, Alan Davey. And it's a disappointing one for the Demons with just a minute 53 left on the clock.
Alan Davey has kicked a goal in every game that he has played this year for the Bombers. And that was a timely one, getting the margin back to 7 points. McKenzie bundled over by Zaharakis. Look at Nate Jones. Efforts to win the ball. Pairs knocked over. Still have the awareness to get rid of it. Bombers look good here. They move the ball by hand. Swift hand movement. As the conditions dry, they're starting to look a little better here now. Collier, short ball. Beautiful, magnificent play. That's what we know the Bombers can do.
Well, Collier found himself in space. Just spread better on Carl Morton. Got that release kick into space. And when you've got an... You see this here, Zaharakis, there's Collier. In too much space, Carl Morton on him. And when you got that time to deliver
inside 50. Might struggle for the distance here, Richo. Monfries, a little bit of a hooker of the ball. It's right on line. It's going to fall right on the line. It's touched.
Oh, good call, BT.
He's not a big kick of the ball, man, Monfries. Pretty accurate, though.
And well done to Jamar to sum up the situation as you did there, Brian, and make sure that's his role to get himself in the right spot to save an important goal.
Players get that sort of information, Darce, that this guy is not a long kick for goal. Would they be furnished with all that sort of detail?
You get a mix of players that study the game ferociously,
yep,
and those that have got no idea about what's coming up. Right under J-Mart.
Give us a no idea guy. You got any no ideas out there? I'll give you time to think about that. It's a question without notice, but now you've got to answer it.
I played with a guy called Craig Ellis, who Melbourne fans might know, played a few games. We had a sheet put in front of us 1 week against Fremantle when they first came to the competition. We were told if we couldn't name half the side, we weren't going to get a game. He put one name down on the sheet, all he could come up with, and it was Jason Akamanis. Fair to say, he didn't follow the game all that closely, my old mate.
Yeah, absolutely.
Takes all types.
I'm not sure. Richo, were you a studier of the game?
Yeah, you need to know certain things. Probably just the defenders you're playing on as a forward.
Under the pressure here, the Demons.
As a midfielder, you need to probably know so much more. The amount of people you rotate through now, you'd have to study a lot of players.
I tell me Tony Lockett would often line up fullback and look alongside. And where have you come from? It might have been Matthew Croft, who played 150 games, or a fullback that had been in the system for 10 years. Plugger had never heard of them.
Gary Abbott Sr. would go, who are you? Ball back in play here now for the Demons. One last opportunity here. A couple of seconds remaining in this quarter. Been a really good quarter here for the Melbourne Football Club to keep the reins on the Bombers. And they would be very proud with their first half efforts. Excellent stuff. They lead it by a goal at half time in a low scoring affair. Been lots of pressure. The Bombers, as the conditions started to dry, just got better and better and better. But Melbourne were very, very effective in that first half of football. Halftime scores here at the MCG. Melbourne lead 4-3-27. Bombers 2-9-21. Great half of footy, boys.
They've given themselves a chance, the Demons. They've absolutely come with a plan. They've been competitive. And a low-scoring affair where they just get inside the heads of the Bombers is their only chance to win this game. That's what they've done at halftime. And now it's up to this group to respond. It would have been fantastic. Have they got the ability to flick the switch, BT? We'll find out in the second half. A lot to look forward to at halftime. It's the Bombers and the Demons, the Melbourne Footy Club, leading by 6 points at halftime.
Coming up on Saturday night, half a football from the Melbourne Football Club against the all-conquering Bombers so far this year. They lead it by a goal at half-time. Melbourne kicking 3 goals to the Bombers, 1 in that second quarter. It was a very good effort indeed. Richo, Das, what do you make of the stats so far?
Well, I make of a low-scoring game, wet weather, Melbourne making a contest of it, Richo, trying to keep this into a situation that Essendon don't want, which is not allowing their running game to get going. And I think Mark Neward has come with the idea of bringing it into a contest. And now it's Essendon who, at half-time, suddenly get a little nervous. They've got to flick the switch on to the intensity required. And there's some doubt Melbourne are a chance.
Yeah, it certainly is. They started to gain some confidence as that quarter went on. The game started with a loose behind the ball for each team. And Melbourne had a really good setup behind the football. Essendon couldn't get their game going. Melbourne got a little bit of a sniff. It turned into a one-on-one battle and they're right in the game at half-time.
They'd be having a good think about it. That is for sure, the Bombers. Bomber Thompson is down there with our own Cameron Ling. Let's find out what he thinks about the first half.
Bomber, 35 inside 50s for the half. Amazing effort, but just not getting the reward for it.
Oh, absolutely, yeah. That's what it was all about at quarter time, and it didn't fix up in that second quarter, so we're going to try and address it at half time and kick more goals.
Moving into the second half, what's the key to getting on top of Melbourne?
We're going to go a little bit harder, a touch harder than we have in the first half. We've got to run and keep possession of the ball by foot. We're handballing a bit much. And just, as you said, just get an effective forward structure to kick goals.
Thanks for your time, Bob. All the best.
Thanks, Cameron. Thanks,
Bomber Thompson down there with Cameron Ling. A little bit of love between those two, I think, from that that smile there from Bomber. Key moment for you, Richo, in the game so far has been Jack Watts. Why?
Yeah, I think he's been fantastic. We highlighted him before the game for what he's been able to do behind the football in the last 2 weeks, and he's continued it on tonight. He's had 16 disposals in this first half. A lot of the time he was situated loose, but that's okay when you read the game as well as this man can. He's the guy to have loose because he can set up and he uses the football well. He's at 95% efficiency, and that's why you would want him to be loose, because he sets you up and he can intercept mark. And this particular one here resulted in a goal down the other end for Morton, and it all started with Jack Watson. I think it's great for his education. Towards the end of that quarter he did play one-on-one on Monfrey, so he is playing on someone as well.
Yeah, I agree with you, Richo. I think he's been fantastic. Sometimes you need a bit of a perfect storm, BT, to pull off a miracle victory. And this would be the upset of the year if Melbourne can do it. What has also fallen their way is the missed opportunities for the Bombers. They have been 0 from 5 set shots in the first half, and times that they could have taken chess marks. You're seeing opportunities here that, you know, really the first 9 games, they've all gone Essendon's way, and they haven't really been able to take the ones that you would think would be. That kick forward is just reckless and not there. Hurley's had some shanks of kicks at goals, really let themselves down in front of goal when they've had a lot of inside 50 and a lot of opportunity on the scoreboard.
Das, it's so hard to be up for the whole season, and maybe Essendon are having a little bit of an off night, but now the challenge is there for them. Can they switch back on? Because Melbourne are gaining some confidence.
Quite right, Richo, because they looked just a little bit off last week against GWS in the motivation stakes as well. On to something there. Let's get down to Cameron Ling. Lingy, you've been following Paddy Ryder in this game. What have you made of him so far?
I have been following Paddy Ryder, and he hasn't been great so far, along with a lot of the Essendon players. He is a player, though, who can
who can turn this game around. He's got the remarkable skills that we know. He can push forward, he can play in the ruck. I love his ruck work. He combines really well with Joe Watson, Brent Stanton, these guys who like to get on the move at stoppages. But Paddy Ryder probably needs to stand up along with a few other players. That's great when you can follow up and lay a tackle like that after a ruck contest. Took this great mark, went back, missed the goal though. We know he's a quality player. I just like to see him do more when the chips are down a little bit and the team's struggling. This is just magnificent. That sort of ruck work is incredible. And that shows how special he is. He needs to lift in this second half, but there's a lot of Essendon players who need to lift as well. And what they've done is by allowing Melbourne to get that confidence, Melbourne are up and about now. It's going to make it harder for them in the second half to get on top.
Nice work down there, Lingy, on the heels of Paddy Ryder. Hey, we saw Jeddah in that quarter, Darce. You mentioned that he'd been warned at the match review panel in the previous week about staging.
It might have been 2 weeks ago. Let's take a look at this one. Tackle around the waist. And I think, Richo, your summation of this was right. It's a habit he's got himself into. Yeah. He throws the head back, give me a free kick. Well, it's just, look, it's not great. I'm not going to try and hang him for it, but I think he might have caught one in the crown jewels at the same time. But you can't do it. Reprimand, maybe give him another warning. I don't want to see him suspended or anything ridiculous, but he's got to get that out of his game.
There's no doubt we don't want to see it coming into our game. It can be a blight on football when you stage, and he did do it in the Dreamtime game. It is an instinctive reaction. I don't think he's meaning to do it, but it doesn't look great.
Hey, live and interactive, BT, we are. Hashtag 7 Sport. We're getting a lot through Toyota, Twitter and Fango joining the conversation. RT73, I like this. Damien Hardwick's first year, we were 0-9, written off by everyone. We won our first in wet weather. Can the D's do the same? Hashtag 7 Sports. So maybe a bit of perspective about Melbourne.
Looking very competitive right at the moment, Darce. Let's have a look at the... Indeed, well, we're going to take a break. On the other side of the break, we're going to come back and find out whether the D's can stay with the Bombers. Who's this, Richo?
That was
Blue Juice
before the game.
Blue Juice.
We had Simple Plan in here. It's been one of those nights, a bit of rock and roll.
Magical night, Richo. The Demons are all excited about their prospects in the second half. So are we. Can the Bombers come out full of fire? We're about to find out. Yes, don't adjust your screens. Melbourne are leading this game at halftime by 6 points over the Bombers. They've played inspired footy, full of presence and pressure, and have been very, very impressive indeed. Boys, Luke Darcy and Matthew Richardson, who's been hot, who's been cold?
Well, the players that we think have been hot have been Jack Watts, who we spoke about at halftime. I think he's been great as a loose man. And Maloney, he's been great. Getting back to somewhere near his best, 13 touches, 3 clearances, which has always been his strength, and a goal.
They're not getting the job quite as you would like in the first half. Jakey Melcham hasn't had a lot of the footy. And Paddy Ryder needs to lift as well. 96% of game time, just the 4 disposals. And he needs a bit of a lift in the second half, along with a few Bomber teammates, Richo, who have been very, very quiet. They need some more intensity. They would have got a big jolt, I think, from the coach James Hurd at half time. But it's game on here. Well, under the Demons, they've kept it low scoring. And they've given themselves a chance for a massive upset, BT.
Always live and interactive, Darce. We've got one here, a tweet from Dallas, Texas. Ken and his son, both local Romsey boys, watching the game over in Dallas, Texas.
In Dallas?
Yes.
What on online?
Online. Richo, great to have you aboard over there.
Nick Revolt's getting married in Texas. Had him before the game.
Yes, him and his cousin Jack. Out of the middle. Great sign for the Bombers. Howlett tries a little bender around the corner.
Oh,
look at Hurley. Boy, that sets the example, doesn't it? Now at ground level, Watson knocked away by Watts, who's been really good in this game. Zarakis, you like the way they've started, the Bombers. I know there's not a lot in 30 seconds of play, Darce.
Hey, there's enough. There's a statement there from Michael Hurley. Look at this. That's why we love him. Get out of my way, Jared Rivers. Raging Bull sort of scenario there, crashing through.
Right up, third man up. There's Melchon. The guy he said was running a little cold at this stage, and a bit of a fumble there, able to make amends. Kicks it long and deep, and here he is again.
Gee, that was good. Looks like he might have got a little
bit of a rev at halftime. He's come out, and this is why he's a good player, because he attacked the ball at ground level, busted the play open, and then he just showed too much strength here in this marking contest, brushed McDonald aside, protected the space where he wanted the ball to land, and jumped into it beautifully. That was a great contested mark.
Hasn't kicked it well tonight. Got a clean, dry ball here to start it, though. And a nice look at it from 35 metres out directly in front. Boy!
He kicked the first two ones on the outside of the boot. That one's come off the inside. Victor, you're a good accurate kick. What's he doing there?
It looked like he dropped it a little high on the actual foot there, Richo, and got it right where the ankle joins the leg, I reckon. But he has kicked poorly all night. Watch back into play. Ball over the line out of bounds.
Let's get down to Dr. Peter Larkins. Welcome to you, Doc.
Yeah, thanks, Darce. Sub-action on the Melbourne bench, Darce. So we're about to see Lyndon Dunn come in. It's Sam Blees, who got really heavily corked in the first quarter, out with a hip problem.
Howe from the stoppage. A little bit of a hand in the back of Sylvia there. Fletcher got away with it.
It's a height mismatch, isn't it, there, that we've been worried about in the one-on-one situation. Fletcher just seems so comfortable in that role. Sylvia has to try and get on the move and use his speed and agility to advantage, because Fletcher has really played that goalkeeper role to perfection tonight again.
Dempsey out of bounds on the full. Melbourne will get a chance, I think, McKenzie, to put this one back into play.
Mark Neal may have almost instructed Colin Sylvia to play almost a negating role on Dustin Fletcher, because a few times when he's had an opportunity to come at the football, he hasn't. He's been more worried about Fletcher.
Zanarakis here. Dempsey. Bad news for the Demons, with his doc reporting Blees out of this game. There's McKenzie. Top to Morton. Stolen by Cramery. Inside to Davey. Turns, fronts the goal. Got it in front of Hurley. Got a go, and he does. Did well working back McDonald, Joel McDonald, and also Tom's in there as well. Ryder, a much more urgent Bomber outfit in this second half. Dyson along the ground. Melksham, another fumble. Little kick around the corner. He's got it working nicely, though. He makes amends and says well done to himself.
Well, a man that we said needed a lift, Jake the Snake Melksham. And we are seeing the response that we probably thought would come, and that is a bit of a lift in intensity for the Bombers, Richo.
Yeah, it certainly looks like. And they probably have copped a spray from Hurdy at half-time, and they've lifted their intensity. There's no doubt about that. And it's probably Hurley set the scene inside 50 early. I know he missed the goal, but he's shown a real attack on the ball, and they've responded.
Bombers lead by a point as a result of this goal.
Yeah, we asked Jake Melksham for a lift. He was another Bomber that had a very quiet first half, and we've just seen that spark, that lift in intensity. Sam Blees, the man, Dr. Peter Larkins, all over. Disappointing for him. Activated sub as a result of Blees' injury.
And Blees had been playing on Melksham, and although he hadn't done a lot himself, Melksham certainly hadn't either.
Just haven't had enough of the ball in this third quarter here. The Demons yet to gain any sort of control on it. Bombers have come out in a much more aggressive fashion.
Well, we expected a response, because below par first half, quality side, quality coaching panel lesson they've got. Now the challenge for the Demons, they've just got to hang tough, make sure they don't get three or four quick goals in a row kicked against them, see if they can peg one back and go in at three-quarter time with a small lead, and then
Jones saying the umpire
again.
Have a look at the scoreboard there. I did handball at Darce. Sorry to cut you off there.
Never known an umpire to glance up, BT, after your point that way.
Pretty embarrassing if you got it wrong.
It's unlucky for Blees. He's only played the three games this year, had that broken leg, and he's got so much promise and pace. Disappointing.
Back around the back, was looking for Hurley. They're two on one here. Hurley went and got it. He said, OK, I'll do this myself. Left foot, no. Back to Collier. Little chip has Joel McDonald off hands. Bombers get another one. Hocking.
They're coming now, the Bombers. They've kicked the first two goals, and That was a great snap around the corner by Hocking, as players now seem to do regularly. There are so many rotations coming off after they've kicked a goal. Hocking puts one through straight to the pine.
Paddy Wright at his four disposals in the first half. Have a look how clever that is. That is a ruck hit out back to the 9 o'clock position if you're taking a centre bounce. Incredible understanding of the game. Hocking gets the goal. The Bombers are away here.
Jack Riewoldt trying to claim a touch off that as well. Ever hopeful. Dempsey. Melbourne got plenty of players here to gobble this up. Gee, Wharton should have taken it initially. Umpire called play on, but it was a late whistle from the umpire. Grimes has got to go down and just tidy things up here a little bit now as they gain control. There's Joel McDonald.
Oh, there, Michael!
Well, this is where Jack Watson's the kick down the line. You've got to stop leading, Jack, and actually just be the release kick because they can't over finesse. They're under pressure. This is where they need a bit of composure, just to hold onto the footy for a moment, make sure they don't turn one over and have three in a row kicked against them.
Doc Larkins.
Yeah, Ricky Dyson has been down the race with the Docks again. He was subbed out of the game with groin soreness last week, Brian, but he doesn't want to get subbed out. He's keen to stay on, Dyson.
Yeah, keep a close eye on him as well, Doc. Wide now, Garland.
Hold there, Dustin! Play on!
Just trying to gain a bit of possession here, the Demons, and stop the bleeding. Tapscott!
Well, that was a good passage of play by Melbourne. As Darce pointed out, they were trapped in that defensive pocket. They couldn't go down the line, so they worked it across the other side of the ground. They were patient. Got the ball inside 50, and it's a good mark by Tapscott, but that was a great build-up. From one end of the ground to the other with kicks and marks, controlled the ball really well.
Hasn't kicked the goal this year, Tapscott, and here he is about 35 metres out. 45-degree angle. There is the angle. Tapscott comes in, was looking for the little right post there, and try to bend it back, couldn't get it done. Carlisle, cool to Fletcher.
Play on!
Fletcher short to Zaharakis. He goes to Ryder on the wing. Sellers does well.
We highlighted Seller at the start of the game and thought that that was going to be a real concern, but credit to him, he has stuck with Paddy Ryder. And Ryder, so far, not the big influence at all.
See that throw in falling. Very short indeed. Dunn, the sub, involved in the picture there as well. Here's Fletcher. Always goes boundary. How's that for a lesson there? Under pressure, turn boundary side. Not back in the middle. And out of trouble. Hocking now to Zaharakis. Starting to find a bit of space, Zaharakis, to Stanton. Wanted it over the top there. Dempsey didn't get it. They went the kick forward instead. And now Tom McDonald's got to tidy it up, and he does. Although the ball was knocked away by Jetta. Panic, the knock on, wide to Hurley. Hurley gathers now to Davey. He went to ground. Jetta was there with him. A little soccer off the ground.
Got out of jail there, Tom McDonald. Richo didn't. He had an easy give handball to run out of defence. Decided to sell some candy and take them on. That's just not playing the percentage. It's not smart.
He had Joel McDonald to handball the ball, running onto his right leg. Joel McDonald is the guy that would be the better user of the football. Tom's the key position player. Give it to the runner. No, released and away, so always give the first option.
Wouldn't it be good tucking into one of those now? Those gentlemen, we believe we've had the cameras on them for a while. That's their third. And they are eating a paper bag and all. Coolish night in Melbourne. Great night for a pie and to watch the footy. Zaharakis to mop up to Dyson. Little give to Pears. Got a late reprieve after initially being omitted in this side with the withdrawal of Hooker. Dempsey around the corner, left foot, looking for Monfries. Used the one hand. Did well Hocking to clear the space. Belt Chambers a little slow to get rid of it. Stanton, the pressure mounting on the Demons. Watts did well to clear the space, but it's going to come back. Dempsey made a mess of it. Trengove. Green had to thread the needle. Got it on to Sylvia. The little short ball, and they're away here now. An opportunity for Garland. He had to go wide because he had nothing long, Darce.
Brilliantly played by Fletcher again. Just guarded the space.
Sylvia now with the opportunity to mark.
They have to swap opponents there. Dempsey had to pick up Sylvia, who Fletcher has been playing on. And he's always been a good overhead mark, Cole Sylvia. He needs to go back and kick this goal. It'll be a settling goal for Melbourne. Keep them in the contest.
Haven't been able to kick goals either team from this position. We know that Howe got an unbelievable goal from the boundary line 5 metres to the right of Sylvia. But
you're our kicking expert. Where does he aim here, Brian?
Just inside right post, I reckon, Darce. And a lot of players are giving the right post away.
You say that with real authority.
In he comes. Just floated across the face, Darce. Sorry, Richo. Where would you have aimed, Richo?
I reckon you just go up the middle at the G. The wind comes in and swirls around, Brian. And
you and goalpost theories don't go that well together.
This ground here, if you look at the flags at one end of the ground, the Ponce would stand, then you look at the other end, they're going in different directions.
This is a man that said the higher the goalpost, the harder it is for him to kick goals. Wow. Bell Chambers. Watson went without it. Howlett just barged his way through a bit of heavy traffic. Look at Elwin spinning and pirouetting. Sylvia just put his head over the ball and won the hard one. Kick out might fall to the advantage. It does. Scarlam.
That's what Colin Sylvia can do as a footballer, what he needs to get back to. They're the things you can control. How hard you smash in at the footy. Hasn't had a great year, Colin Sylvia. Had some injury issues, but that's great. Just bulldozing your way through, using that powerful frame. And good response from the Demons. They need a goal for reward for the effort they put in the last 5 minutes.
Normally a defender playing forward. No goals this year for Garland. 45 metres is the journey and sprays it right. Badly right.
That was a kick of a defender, I guess. Colin Garland, he's played up forward tonight and I reckon he's been solid. He gave them a target early, got involved in the game, and most importantly, as a forward, he moved around and was getting himself to a lot of contests.
Fletcher.
He's taken the 6 marks. He's been good.
Melksham starting to get a bit of ball. Well, Chambers, here comes Stanton to get a bit of a nudge. Offhand, Zaharakis with speed. Elwin Davey with a shepherd. Did well, Zaharakis. Probably could have kept running. Now Joel McDonald's got it to do. Got Jetter in the tackle. He keeps his feet, which is important. Did well, the Demons, on that occasion. Jetter says sorry to his teammates.
Leroy Jetter, we were talking and having a bit of a crack at him about maybe staging in the first half. Stinger 3 has tweeted through. Darce and Richo, Jetter isn't the only player who throws his head back. Maybe ease off him. It happens every match.
And it probably does.
We didn't say he was the only player. We were just commenting on that one incident. Every player's been accused of putting a little bit extra on a free kick at times.
Richo, just a little niggly. A word of warning for any of those tweeters out there that just don't get Richo offside, the people's person, because he's starting to turn on you all out there.
He gets defensive,
yeah,
Richo.
He does.
You don't want to take him on.
Offhands picked up by Clark, almost a high tackle from Monfries, and another one there for Clark on Cramery, I thought. Umpire lets it roll under enormous pressure. The D's. Jack did what he should have done as a defender.
Well, we don't want to see what happens in soccer where players do stage for free kicks.
And up by now, McBurney there. Jack kicked it before he signaled it. I know that is to the letter of the law, but that's half a millisecond.
But McBurney does umpire to the letter of the law, and he's a very much a stickler for the detail in our game, and I've got a problem with that. His pairs off the inside of the boot without great authority. Hurley just goes bang, cleared the space for Jetta. Hurley aggressive, barging, bruising encounter.
He's a cannonball, Michael Hurley. He throws his weight around. Look at this. You get hit hard when his frame runs into you.
Tapscott's a big boy as well.
Sure. I wonder why he's gone down. Why has Hurley gone down, Lingy, to the bench, do you reckon?
I'm not 100% sure, BT. He's talking to a few of the players and he's got the headphones on now, but he probably wants to know what the communication is like down there. Are the leaders of the team driving the way this Bombers team wants to play? Forgetting about the scoreboard, just how we want to play.
I saw the weapon on screen there right alongside his man.
Oh, absolutely. Just Hurdy getting all the information off the man responsible for strength and conditioning down there. The weapon, an opportunity here for Collier, slung in the tackle, ball stuck in there. Umpire says play on.
He's holding it in.
Just doubles his security a bit too, Dean Roberts and the weapon.
I've got one here from Graham Fraser. Says, actually met the weapon today. Very nice bloke to talk to and laughs at the way you guys talk about
it. We love the weapon.
Yep. He is a man with a huge job and he's turned the Bombers' fortunes around. Make no mistake. Off hands. Collier with a left foot snap. Gets it right for the Bombers. 3 in a row in the third quarter.
Oh, they're so dangerous inside forward 50. The Bombers with their stoppage work. They've always got a Bell Chambers or Ryder normally down there, resting ruckman or playing forward. And when you've got someone like that
inside forward 50, you can get a lot of goals from stoppages.
Here's the goal, left foot snap under pressure. There's Travis Collier, 25 gamer tonight. James Hurd has wandered down to the boundary line and getting around the group with a bit of positive energy at the moment. Three in a row.
Biggest lead of the game, Das, 15 points in favour of the Bombers.
Interesting to hear him last week, James Hurd, say the main thing he's taken out of Kevin Sheedy is always having a positive outlook on what's happening in a game of football, and might explain why he's down there.
Doing that on the bench with Joe Botts as we speak.
Boys, free kick paid off the ball here to Carl Morton for Melbourne. Heath Hocking, I think he was holding on or high contact.
Nice work, Lingy. Morton. Good ball to Grimes. Had to go, and he did.
They desperately need one here, Melbourne. Need to just get one back on the
stay in touch, don't they? Last goal for the Demons came at the 15-minute mark of the second quarter. There's Mitch Clark stretching. Hands Howlett, just a reliable contributor, Howlett. Maloney wanted it back off Sylvia, got it just a little heavy and harsh on the handball. Couldn't get it, Maloney.
It was the right play from Maloney. Tried to absorb the pressure, I should say Sylvia. He had Maloney running alongside of him. Wasn't able to do it.
Clark, beautiful little palm down on the path of Jones. High tackle there, Nicholson. Taken pretty high, as you can see the end of that.
Let's go straight up.
There is that positive reinforcement you're talking about to players.
He's very comfortable in his skin as a coach, James Hurd, doesn't he? You can see
he's always calm, isn't he?
He doesn't look like he's trying to do it all. He's doing his bit, and he knows he's got great support around him, which is exactly what happens on the field when good teams are up and going. Doesn't look like he has the whole responsibility on his shoulders.
He's obviously come down for a specific reason, hasn't he? Looks like he's going back up now.
With 8 minutes left, that's very, very interesting. Let's see if Lingy can find out a little bit more about that. Here's Morton, has a flying, inaccurate shot at goal. Lingy, any other possible reasons? I mean, we see that he's gone back up to the coaching box now, James Hurd.
I can only assume, BT, that he wanted to look blokes like Joe Watson in the eye and talk to them and see what's going on out in the field. Hear it straight from them. See the reaction when they come off the ground so we can have a really good quality conversation with them rather than it being over the phone. And now he's back up there because he wants to see the overall picture.
Look at Dyson. He knew he had to get back onto his left. Melbourne players didn't know it, though. Hurley just drawing a direct line with him and the ball as he's done this half. Howlett too wide.
And Michael Hurley, just show you that. Without kicking bags of goals or necessarily being best on ground, just a sheer attack on the footy can spark a side and 10 seconds into the second half, we all sat back and went, they've responded because of one contest, and that was Michael Hurley just smashing in a lot harder than they'd done in the first half.
Opportunity for Hardingham. Boy from Cogin up in Western Australia, the weak belt territory down there, the knock away from Jones. Green went without it. Spills to Cramery. Over the top, Stanton sets up Hocking. Hocking sees Davey wide. They arrive in numbers. Watts did well. Melksham run down from behind.
You're spot on, BT. Jack Watts came off his direct opponent there to fist that ball away. And then a great tackle from Lyndon Dunn from behind. So they're hanging in there. They need a goal for their efforts here, Melbourne.
Yeah, get the feeling the pressure is mounting on the Demons now. Watch was being held, should have got a free, nothing on. Davey, can he bust the last one? Ball knocked loose by Tom McDonald. Nicholson tidies it up, gave it to McKenzie. Under enormous pressure here, the D's defence at the moment. Can they hang on? Stanton over the top. Love it, Murray there.
Essendon
free against Morton. Lovett Murray looks inboard, nothing there.
Bit going on with Tringove and Melksham off the ball.
There is indeed, little hold there. In the meantime, the play goes on and Melbourne happy to secure the boundary line. And here's what's going on behind the play. A little clip there from Jakey Melksham to Tringove.
He's a tough nut, Jakey Melksham. The effort defensively before from Tom McDonald. It's a goal saver, pickpocket style. I might come back and revisit that in a minute.
Right up. Sweeping knockdown. Dunn got on the end of it. He was a sub activated in the absence of Blees. Got a groin problem, says the doc. Down low. Lovett Murray.
Sends it high. Look at the numbers up. Three of them up for the Demons. Jetta, the only one down. Got the resultant ball. Gave it off to Stanton. He said, give me some space. I'm a good kick. I can get this around the corner. Rivers did well defensively. Ball knocked away. Pressure mounting big time on the Bombers. On the Demons, I'm sorry. 5.5 remaining in this quarter.
Look at this goal saver there. Picked the pocket. Davey was gone through, running into an open goal. And Tom McDonald, reflex action, got the footy in its entirety. Saved a certain goal.
Grimes. Demons need a steadier. Good ball to Garland.
Thank you.
Garland downfield, got Sylvia over the back. Pears is there with him. Sylvia will beat him back in the foot race. Needs to be clean at the ground level. Pears monitoring the progress of Sylvia. Carefully watching. And that's a bit of a win for the Demons.
Sylvia's definitely lifted his work rate this quarter. I'm liking the work of Jared Rivers on Cramery tonight. He's the second most scoreboard impact for the season in the AFL, Cramery, and he's been held goalless so far by Rivers, one of their leaders. Heard him speaking during the week, and he's backing it up. Some good leadership tonight.
Desperate need of a goal, the Demons here. Melksham in there. Trent Gove's got him in the tackle. Dyson upended by Green. Jay Mars there. Zarakis wants the ball as well. Little knock clear to Dempsey. Out of trouble. The left footed Dyson immediately heads to the wing. Watches there. Does well. Almost ran off the line. Umpire didn't call play on there. Now,
hold there.
In the hands of Magna.
Disposal number 20 for Jack Watts.
Mitch Clark, he needs to push up here and make a contest of this from the goal square.
Magna, here he comes now, Richo. Got interrupted his run, and he's a shepherd there. And that is a correct free.
Right there.
Just been watching, see Mitch. He had to run all the way from the goal square there to get involved. And he did, and he drew a free kick.
The ball.
Ball wasn't within the required distance, and it was off the ball. And he didn't have his eyes on the ball, Dempsey.
Hasn't been in a lot of contests tonight. His work rate, not sure if it's where it has been this year, but he did on that occasion make a contest. And if you get there, you draw free kicks.
Bit of a flat top hairdo and a bit of artwork to go with that. Look at that hairdo. In comes Mitch Clark. A big goal, a big kick for the Demons. They need it, and they have got it. And they are back in this game. 3:30 remaining in the third.
He's having a good season. Mitch Clark, of course, a lot of press over the summer coming down from Brisbane. But he's produced for the D's. He's been a good target inside forward 50. And he's been pretty reliable when he gets shots on goal this year.
He's pretty good on the lip too, Richo.
Yeah, he enjoys it.
Said to Jakey Carlisle. There's more where that came from.
Fans enjoying the moment here at the MCG on the back of Mitch Clark's goal, their first in over a quarter. And they are back in the hunt here, just 8 points down the Bombers. Knocked down to Zaharakis. Was looking to respond. Boy, Rivers got under that ball. Handball straight to Hurley in the end. Tom McDonald, nice bear hug tackle. Hunting it down, Zaharakis. Watson just got rid of it to Hocking. The pressure's coming from the Demons. Ryder felt it. Now, how will they rule this? Maloney in the tackle. Ball spills out. No need to rule it. Here's Zaharakis from 60 metres. Cut off by Rivers.
It's been good. Rivers just spoke about him. Cramery's come from the ground. He finds himself without an opponent at the moment.
Tapscott to Maloney to Jones. Jones had to go wide. That's a lucky kick to Garland in the end. Monfries waited for the troops. Howlett, sharp hands, Pears. What do I do? Pears, he said. Magna, great and tackle.
It was disposal. Just desire to hunt the body there from James Magna. One of my favourites. Melbourne Footy Club works really hard and have lifted here.
Magna goes out near the boundary line. Clark up with a knock. Pairs again. Not clean with the ball skills and gives away the free.
But that was great, Mitch Clark. You don't always have to take marks as a forward. Brought it to ground.
Nicholson to Dunn. Gee, had great body position then, Lyndon Dunn. And that one's over the line.
He did, Brian. He held. He protected the space well. He just couldn't quite release enough to get that chest mark.
Or released a little early. Yeah. Allowed his defender into the drop zone to spoil.
Here is Mitch Clark and Paddy Ryder. Melbourne a real chance here. Bombers playing some of their better footy in this third quarter, in the early parts of it.
It's going to be tough to get a stoppage out of this Melbourne. Two extra Bombers around the play.
There's Neil Craig, the mentor coach for Mark Neild. Bomber Thompson playing the same role for James Hird. It's a new development in AFL football, and one that I think has got a lot of merit to it to support some of the new coaches coming through.
I like it. And you get the feeling that'll be what happens at GWS with Sheedy and Williams. It's the other way around at the moment, but I like it, Darce. It's sensible. It keeps the older coaches in the game, and they're still very much worth every cent.
And that is a great thing, because in the past, these people who had a lot to contribute, a lot of intellectual property, exited footy clubs and were lost to the game. Well, if you can support people of that calibre, Neil Craig, Bomber Thompson doing it, Rodney Eade doing it at the Magpies as well, then I think it's a smart move footy clubs are developing.
Gee, a goal would be handy here for the Dees. They've been pressing for the last 3 or 4 minutes. Goal just before three-quarter time. We have them level.
City into the G. Magna through some traffic. Watson upset his runs. Arrakis over the line. Let's go down to Doc Larkins.
Yeah, Sam Lottingham's been doing a bit of warm-up in the last few minutes, Brian. No concern in specific Essendon players, but three-quarter time, usually you're getting your sub ready in case there's going to be a sub at that time.
Rarely had the chance to use their sub when they've wanted to, Doc, this year, haven't they?
That's right. It's a luxury for them to get a player at three-quarter time and still be fresh.
Absolutely. A minute to go in the third quarter. Bombers did well kicking the first three goals of the quarter, and Melbourne just starting to come back in it now within 8 points.
They've been good around the clearances tonight. They're in front by six. They just need to get Maloney or Jones free here.
All in dispute at this stoppage at the moment. No clear winner. Dempsey. Look at Magna. Appetite for the ferocious ball is unbelievable. A man that single-handedly built Eastlink. James Magna, according to himself.
Few bricks and gets up at 5:30 every morning to avoid the traffic, drives along Eastlink, reminds himself that was where he's come from, and prides himself on being the hardest worker at the Melbourne Footy Club.
For those interstate viewers, Eastlink, one of the new freeways built over here in Victoria.
And I said that our taxpayers' money was spent on it. It's privately owned.
Of course.
So, yes, shows you how much I know, but I was corrected on Twitter, as you normally are on Twitter. They don't miss much out there.
You may not have been through the tolls out there, Richo, but they do charge money. Ryder. Ground level ball. Melksham. McDonald. Joel ran past. Trent goes to Jamar. Time ticking away. Under half a minute. You think the only ones that can score in this quarter from here will be the Demons. Melksham, the boy from the Calder Cannons, around the corner. Straight into the hands of Rivers. Right in the eye, diddle-diddle of the G. One last chance here, the Demons, to score. 15 seconds under. Jones needs to move the ball.
Just needs to get it long, you can see.
Look at the runner coming up behind him here. You see him in the picture, telling him about the clock. He says, move it quickly. Siren sounds. Interesting quarter of football. Bombers owned the first half of it with three goals. Melbourne responded with a late one. And at three-quarter time, make no mistake about it, this game is very much up for grabs. The Bombers by just 8 points. Big game at the G. It was missed opportunities for the Bombers early in the game. Hurley was an offender in that area. Neil counted the numbers and got them right because Melbourne were on fire in the first half. The skid factor here from Maloney was intelligent football as the Demons raced away to a 13-point margin with this kick, banana style from Jones. It was magnificent towards the end of the second quarter. It was rough and tough and the scuffles were there. The pressure was there. Hurley came out charging in the third quarter, showed the aggression the Bomber fans wanted. And in the end, Hurley, with his aggressive nature, allowed and created the opportunity here for Melksham to put the Bombers in front by 1 point in the early stages of the third quarter. A very, very interesting game it has been. Bombers by 8 points here at three-quarter time. 5-5, 35 to Melbourne,
5:35 to Essendon, 5:13:43. Cameron Ling.
BT, we've spoken a lot about Essendon's big, strong, mature bodies, but what they've been able to do tonight is break the Melbourne tackles, the lighter bodies of Melbourne. They've been able to... Jaggy Melksham got through there where he shouldn't have got through. Melbourne have got to nail that. They've been strong and hard in the contest. They are the least caught holding the ball team in the entire AFL, Essendon, and it's those strong bodies that are getting them on top in this game, and I would expect to continue late in this game.
Cameron Lee, 5 lead changes in this game so far. Dust?
Yeah, we're man on man to start the final quarter. Jack Watts has been loose at stages. He's picking up Angus Monfries, and they've got Fletcher at the moment, manned up with Sylvia at full forward.
Can the D's win their first of the year, or is it going to be the Bombers with win number 9?
Well, they're getting the hands on the ball tonight a lot more than they have this year, Melbourne. They're winning the clearances. If they continue to do that, I think they can stretch the Bombers to the end tonight, BT.
Trengove lucky not to be penalised there for not knocking it out after initially dragging it in. Umpire McBurney throwing it up. Jamar knocked down as... the activation of the sub. You can see Lonigan into play here for the Bombers.
It's going to be a one-on-one battle for the rest of this game now. Matchups all over the ground.
Knocked down here to Jones. To Trengove. Kicks it out into open territory. Collier turns around. Little kick. He was looking for the centre-half forward ball to watch and didn't get there in the end. Cut off, and now they're on their way here. Nicholson of Melbourne down towards Tapscott. Fletcher was there, banged him into the signage, and a little sore as a result of this is Tapscott.
BT, as you can see there, Alwyn Davies, the man who's been subbed off the ground for Sam Lonigan.
Well, Tapscott comes back on, and that could have been nasty.
Absolutely. Ball in dispute at the moment. Howlett tackled by Trengove when he didn't have it. Look at the player's desperation in here. Trengove gave it to Jamar in the end. He said, here, kick that forward if you can. Fletcher the knockaway.
Let's have a look at this. Tapscott and Fletcher colliding, and he really rammed himself hard into the fence. Fortunately, okay.
So this is Melbourne's goal end in this final quarter. McKenzie to Maloney around the corner. Carlisle.
Hold there.
Jakey Carlisle out of the Calder Cannons footy factory into the middle, finds Jetta. Jetta's got space and time. Kicks it in the path of Monfries. Hurley's going to arrive as well. Little squeezer through a tight little gap. Ryder keeps his feet. Spin out of the pack was magnificent from Paddy. Couldn't quite finish.
Yeah, he's got away with one there. Seller went to ground, Ryder kept his feet, and you do that in the game of footy and your opponent goes to the ground. When you're one man down and Ryder just couldn't quite make the most of it.
So just repeating that sub for the Bombers. Lonigan onto the ground. Elwyn Davey has been taken out of the game. So both subs activated now. Jamar. McKenzie. Carlisle was able to grab possession, but Jones is going to run it down the middle. Got running support in Rivers. Rivers bangs it onto the boot now. Here's Green. The experience of Green against Pears. Did well to Trengove. Trengove's got the loose man. Can't quite get him on the full. Magna. And Fletcher did well.
Yeah, Cole Sylvia is definitely, you know, playing that negating role on Fletcher, but Fletcher just continues to come up with the football and get involved. I just think he's got to just worry about his own game a little bit now and lead and present and make Fletch defend on him.
Howe. Quick ball to Jones on the left boot. Got it high. Hasn't quite got the journey underneath. And it's Sylvia. Gee, I thought he almost had that Sylvia on the chest when others had misjudged it around him. He barges out of the ball. How did he get that? Sylvia around the corner over the shoulder. Magnificent Colin Sylvia.
On cue, Richo. That's what you asked him to do. Don't worry so much about what Fletcher's doing. See if he can cause some headaches the other way, and he's capable of doing it. Stood up at the right moment.
Yeah, he competed well in the air. He took Fletch back to the goal square. Made a contest in the air, but got after the footy at ground level, and we know what a good player he can be. He finished off nicely. Where's Cole Sylvia? He attacked the ball in the air, then got back after it at ground level and just used his bullocking strength to get out of it. And he is a good finisher. He's been a quality player. He's shown the ability to kick five goals in a game in the past.
Have a look at that Grimes clearance out of the middle. Kick up there towards Garland. Defender gone forward tonight. Done a good job. Kick around the corner. One on one. Couldn't get it done, Clark. Well done, Jake Carlisle. And now Zarakis. The runner's on for the Bombers. The response here. Stanton. One bounce. Thought about the second. Went with a high ball to Ryder. Ryder in front of Seller. Did well. Knocked down. Went and got it there, Nicholson. Really good play to Seller. Seller brings it up towards Maloney. To think Luke Darcy completely dismissed the chances of Melbourne early in this game, Darce. Look at this, the Demons surge forward again at the back, Clark, off hands.
How ridiculous from you, Brian, but Dan Boy DM Wires has tweeted through. He wants Lingy and Richo to get off the fences, enjoying the final quarter. Come on, boys, declare it. Who is going to win the game from here? Richo.
I think Essendon will still win. In a close run, I think the D's will push them all the way tonight.
What about you, Lingy?
I'm messing it all the way. I think they'll get the job done. But Melbourne are playing terrific footy at the moment. Interesting thing at three-quarter time, boys, as Melbourne get themselves out of trouble here, was Mark Neal pulled the entire leadership group aside and spoke to them, asked for a really special effort at the start of this last quarter, which they're giving. Let's see if they can sustain it.
Darce, have we got you to change your mind?
I haven't changed my mind. Melbourne will cause the upset of the year and win the game from here.
Oh, Darce.
You said it early.
They're no hope early on. Unbelievable change of colours. Here goes Maloney. Fletcher's back there. Got the punch away. Sylvia rammed in the tackle from Stanton. Clark with a handball. An opportunity. Dunn gives it off to Magda. The boy from Eastlink. Oh. He built the whole thing and he missed the goal.
They are coming though.
James Hurd says, what is going on?
Colin Sylvia's got himself involved inside 50.
This is what happens, Darce. As I told you earlier, scoreboard pressure can do funny things to good sides.
Absolutely, and that's what's happening right at the moment. Start to just make mistakes you wouldn't normally do. Not there from Dusty Fletcher, cool under pressure.
Lee Matthews has always said that, scoreboard pressure can change the outcome of games. Free kick will go the way of Grimes, I think it is here.
So what they've done well is restricted that half-back run. We saw Stanton have to second-guess himself in a turnover. They'll go inside 50 again here.
He does. Clark lines himself up for the sit at the back. Carlisle with the punch away. Covering off as Morton. Over the line, but they get another look inside their forward 50. They are just 1 point down.
And they've got a good structure set up behind the football here. The D's, they need to just score.
Trento.
Had it locked in for a while.
McKenzie, they lost Blees earlier in the game, if you've just joined us. There is Nicholson.
He had a man on the fat side, needs to kick this now.
That was Garland on the fat side. Nicholson comes in and drills the long ball, Richo! He knew what he was doing, was it touched?
Well, they're calling for a replay. Mitch Clark and the Demons in the goal square. The umpire, no hesitation.
No, he's certain. Boy, oh boy.
That's what it's there for.
They didn't go to the replay.
Well,
I've seen them go to the replay for a lot less than that.
Zaharakis, the response. Here's Collier, gets it into Hurley. Hurley, one hand, says I can do it. Picks it up off the deck. We'll need a left foot snap around the body. Couldn't get it done. Boy, oh boy.
Well, how about the controversy at the other end? Let's have a look at the replay.
I reckon that's a goal.
That angle looks as clear as we've seen.
Well, you can't see the actual contact.
Well, regardless, it should have been worth a look and a second and a third. That's some consultation.
That shot we had from above, it looked like it had nearly got over, Darce, I reckon.
Darce, you mentioned that they have taken a look this year at a lot less than that. Do you reckon they've been instructed to stop taking a look?
He was just sure of himself, wasn't he? The goal umpire, no hesitation. I suppose if he's right, let's be honest, he's a metre away from it, but you'd like the surety of a second look on that one.
Lingy with a conspiracy theory. I like it, Lingy.
He's just starting to warm to this media.
He's just starting to drill a couple, and there's the sling tackle there. Dunn advances it forward. Green flies. Fletcher did well again. And let's just have another look, top view here. Gee, from that angle, it I won't absolutely say the whole ball is over conclusively.
It's not conclusive, but gee, I reckon it was at least worth a look.
The question is, would the review system have been able to clear that decision?
I don't think they could.
So in the end,
probably a good decision then.
Yep. Go with the goal umpire, I guess. But boy,
what a good story, you both.
Here's Lonigan. Once he's in and under. Quick handball from Tom McDonald. Collier gets on the end of it. I tell you what, I'm just starting to sense a little bit here from the Bombers as well. The urgency has all of a sudden come up a notch or two in this game. Monfrey's back to Zaharakis. Has to bust this tackle.
Great tackle.
Tom McDonald, you star.
Well, that's the sort of thing that wins you games of footy against the odds. Chase, hard run, Richo. That was a brilliant effort.
Yeah, it was fantastic. And they have doubled the Bombers' possession this quarter, Dust. 50-25. Something they haven't been able to do all year.
Nicholson again. He's right in the thick of things here at the moment. For the Demons, short ball. Here's Tapscott. Getting all the possession, as Richo said. Comes in there, couldn't mark it, Morton. Little kick out the side door. Maloney gobbled it up, said, what do I do now? Great smother by Hocking. And a free kick to Hocking. He play on, he took him on. You heard the umpire. Tapscott rams it home. Here comes over the top Garland. James Hurd says, boy, what can I do about this? Garland to put the Demons in front.
Yeah, I'll tell you what, this is a good coaching move tonight by Mark Neild. He's thrown Colin Garland forward, been known, Darcy, as a defender his whole career. He's been good. He's given them a target. Hasn't kicked a goal, but 16 possessions, 9 marks is a good night up for it.
Hasn't kicked a goal for the year. 30 metres out, directly in front. Look at this. Melbourne are in front. Successive goals from the Demons by 3. And the fans have found voice.
They're hyperventilating, the Melbourne fans. Have a look at them. Great perseverance. Mark Neild approaches the bench. Game right on here. And Colin Garland, the defender, turned forward, kicks his first of the night. Look at the celebration. How about the energy suddenly around the Melbourne Footy Club? Fans that have been persevering Melbourne supporters, they are out of their seats.
Das, how dare you give them no chance at the start of this game?
They've
kicked
this
3 in a row. Boy, excuse me, how? On to Joel McDonald around the corner. Love it, Murray. Off hands, Morton went without it. Stanton now. Clearing kick, Monfries is under it. He's got to beat a couple. They spoil each other in the end. I think it might have been Rivers along with Watts. Watson, beautiful handball. An opportunity back inside here to Collier. Collier gives it back. Cramery didn't take possession. Intelligent play. Here comes Hurley. He ran past it. Hurley ran past the ball. Cramery's kick was smothered. And Melbourne are all over the Bombers.
That was a great... There was about 3 or 4 brilliant defensive efforts there. And Jack Watts has got to settle it now. Just calm it down for a second. Joe Watson's hands at ground level there before were unbelievable, though. Set his team away. They couldn't finish it off.
Well, that'll disappoint Jack Watts. He just... They have to do the basic things right there. Pop that one out of bounds on the forward. Now they've got to get back in numbers and defend with their lives here.
This will define the Bombers a little bit here, whether they've got the poise. We know they're a good side. Are they a good side with the heat? We're about to find out here now in this game.
Oh, that's great play from Jared Rivers there. The body work was sensational. Again, just under pressure.
Sneak. They've got no numbers behind the ball. Just need to push back defensively. The midfielders here and help out.
Monfries. A lot of space on the fat side of the ground. Couldn't get it over the top, though. Cramery fight there. Couldn't hold the mark. Clever tap onto Green. Green to the runner, Jones. Here go Melbourne again. They've gone wide. Jamar's just come off the bench. Really needed to mark that. Dempsey runs away. He can go all the way to 50 from here. Took a bounce. 55 out. Jack Watts will save the day. He's dropped the mark, but recovers. Gentleman Jack. Kicked the last 3 of the game, the Demons, to lead it by 5. The Bombers have got 10 minutes to find something.
They need to get their hands on the footy, the Bombers. They're just being totally outplayed this quarter. Melbourne are controlling possession, 68-37.
Doubling their possession.
Can't get their hands on it. It's something, as I said before, they haven't been able to do. They're running now.
Green to Morton. Morton will mark uncontested. Rightly brings it back. Now they've got Mitch Clark long in the square. He's caught behind at the moment. Ball knocked to the boundary.
Right play for Morton. Great build up. They had the overlap run go, but the execution for Morton was the wrong one. He was going back Mitch Clark with the flight. He had to get some air in the ball and give the big forward an opportunity. They have it inside their 50. They've got to put some pressure on, keep it in, and force a score.
Collectively, the most amount of goals we've had in a quarter is four in this game. There's two kicked already. You wouldn't think there's more than two more goals in the entire game. Which way they go, we're about to find out. Zaharakis, Hurley, the fight there over the back. Bell Chambers couldn't get down enough. Tom McDonald again.
They're fumbling the Bombers, BT. That was another one at ground level that should have been picked up.
Joel McDonald didn't go wide enough with the kick then. He tried to find the target rather than put it between the target and the boundary. Watson with great poise. Got it to Zaharakis. He's kicked some memorable goals from this position. But not this time.
And Jetta is not happy at all there, boys. Wide open inside 50, about 20 out, and he's giving it to Zaharakis.
Yeah, well spotted, Lingy. He torched him. He just had him, Zaharakis. Had the blinkers on. Just the basic things for Essendon, missing opportunities they should take.
Almost 43,000 people here tonight have witnessed an absolute scrap. Make no mistake, the Demons have been superb tonight. Look at the hands from Clark. They go forward again. Fletcher's the last man standing at that end of the ground.
It's just going to be the team at the most precious situation here that shows the most poise. It always isn't a tight one. It'll be the player who can do something special in a tight situation will win the game.
Live and interactive, Nathan Moore with a tweet. Can it happen? Can Melbourne pull off the upset? I hope so, says a Melbourne supporter. They go into the goal square. Marked by Garland. Goal! They lead it by 11.
Well, if you judge body language on effort and performance, have a look at the way this group, as James Hurd sucks in some water and decides that he needs to do something about it. There's some notable onlookers. Mark Neal, one of them.
He's come down to the boundary now. Wants to get involved and talk to his players. He's sensing his first win, and if ever a man deserves a win, it is Mark Neal. He's copped a lot. This kick here from Jones, he did that deliberately. Saw Garland in the square, kicked it on the outside of his boot, and Colin Garland, he's been a real handful up forward tonight for a guy who's defended most of his career.
Jones out of the middle, and Melbourne up and about. They lead it by 11 points. The Bombers are going to have to kick two goals to beat them. Dyson back to Hocking, inside to Jetta. Jetta to Lonigan. Horrible kick from Lonigan. Can Cranberry pick it up? No, he can't. Hurley can. Looks for an oncoming runner. Lonigan, great smother there in the end by McKenzie, I think it might have been. Joel McDonald went in. Harder than him, though, was Lonigan. Stanton near the boundary line. Keeps it alive. Gives the Bombers a chance. Rivers, what does he do? Found the space to McKenzie. Now it's Melbourne under pressure. Tightening the screws here, the Bombers. And just want you to have a look at this replay. Zaharakis a moment ago, boys. Just as we may not get a chance here in the field of play. Loop it back in now, and Bell Chambers does the work. Done. Ground level, Dyson all over it. Lonigan trying to extract the ball. Clever tap, Stanton got it on the Jetta, right on the boundary. Discipline kick to the top. Cranberry, was he held? No. Rivers goes to ground. Cranberry to Watson. Watson with a little poker. He's got it. The Bombers are back.
He's a ripper, that man. The Essendon skipper. He's racked up 31 disposals, his second goal. Kicked one when he had no right to there. Look at the effort, look at the exhaustion. One of the best handful of players in the competition. The captain found something when his team most needed it.
He's absolutely spent there too, Job Watson. This is what we're talking about before, just the poise and the quality in a tight situation. And it's that man there, Job Watson, the skipper. It's the ball. He didn't have much time to put it on his boot from a tight angle. Kicks the goal, and that's what the match winners do. It's what the A-grade players do, produce when it's most required.
Melbourne by 5 points with 7 minutes remaining. Watson with the goal to get the Bombers back in this one here. Centre half forward for the Demons.
Thrown Joe Watson to full forward now. Jack Watts picking him up.
The MCC members on his non-preferred side advanced it down the boundary line. Love it, Murray. Disciplined. Howlett and Collier there. Magna, look at the hard heads over this. The attack on the ball, it's almost going to be impossible to stop the Demons. Aggressive nature now. It's just the Bombers have got to find a way through in a cool, calm, methodical way.
Really like that move, Joe Watson. Richo, you pointed out now in full forward. Such a good one-on-one player. He's going to cause a lot of nervous tension for Jack Watts if he has to play on him at fullback.
He's 190 centimetres, Darson. Has played a lot of footy forward as a junior, and he's a big man.
Green. Went to ground. Dyson now gathers the ball. You get the feeling the Bombers really applying the screws here at the moment. Trengove dropped the sitter. 5 points in the game. Over the top, mark taken by Magna. Handball off to Green. Green's got it in a perfect position for Maloney and Dempsey go at it. Lucky not to give away the free. Great pick up, Hardingham. He was stripped. Sylvia ran into the oncoming pairs and was thrown on his back. Dempsey now to Carlisle.
A lot of supporters, neutral ones, getting involved in this one. Live and interactive, Tim Bone says, go Melbourne. Not even a Demon supporter. I just think this is awesome footy. Great Saturday night game we've got here.
Great. Oh, absolutely, Richo.
Great effort by Dempsey on Maloney. I thought Maloney had the run of that going back inside 50. Dempsey brought the ball to ground, saved a goal.
Well, we're going to have a ball up here. Mark Neild must be feeling the nerves at this stage, and he's on his feet. James Hurd, on the other hand, is just in no man's land. What can he do? Not much from this stage. It's up to the players. Zaharakis had the handcuffs on before. Kick inside 50 this time. Watson and Watts go at it. Watts been really good in this game. Once again, Watson kept his feet. Did he throw it?
Hey, Richo, they played that really well as they get it moving quickly. We both were pointing forward line. They've created so much space. Watson had the whole 50 on Watts, and Watts stood up pretty well.
He did. That was a great test for a young player on an absolute champion, Watson.
Tapscott takes a lovely mark. They're not going into their shells at all with four and a half. Tapscott launches a long ball. It's one-on-one with Garland. He's kicked two in the last quarter.
Oh, no. And
it'll go against him.
I reckon the umpire was in two minds right until the last second, Richo, and decided to call the sling. I think he was going, oh, I might pay a mark, I might go the other way.
There's one that was played to Buddy Franklin today in Launceston. There was a lot more slinging than that in the contested mark, and you just want consistency with those rules.
Well, the pressure from Demons has forced the turnover. Here's the skipper, Trengove. A careful bounce of the ball on the right hand. Now a centering ball up. They go, no winner in the air.
Oh,
Fletcher. Magnificent. Zaharakis. Jamar. Handball over the top from Seller. High ball. Melbourne a chance again. Dunn crashes into the pack. No win. Here is Mitch Clark. Advances. Gathered by Howe. Goes for a second crack. Gives it to Grimes. The co-captain from the boundary line. High ball. Gee, Beltambers would want to move his feet a little.
Well, Grimes has nearly kicked a miracle goal there, BT, but I hate to be too critical. That one had to come into the centre and play the percentage. It wasn't the time to do that. He could have gone back on his right foot and created some more pressure.
If you're sitting at home and you're a Melbourne fan, stand up, because you're going to need to just to hang on here. Seller. The Bombers have been brilliant all year. Lost one game by a point. And here is the team that has looked hopeless for most of the year in a position to win.
I hate to say it, but I tipped this. Rich Onling, he said it was Bombers all the way in the final quarter. This will be the upset of the year. Look at Mark Neal on his feet.
You did tip it, but you didn't hate to say it, Dash. You actually love saying that.
And you tipped it the other way. Gave the Bombers every chance. Gave Melbourne no chance at all. And look at this. 4-point margin. Down under 3 minutes now. Kick to Tapscott. Dempsey at the back, got time. Oh. Little bit of a fumble. Here comes Tapscott. He's a hard nut. Now Sylvia. Fossick's the ball out. Gave the handball to Garland. He turns around. He's turned his man inside out. Oh. And he's hit the post.
Colin Garland. He's playing like Royce Hart at the moment.
Tell you what, one more behind from the Demons will ensure no worse than a draw, I'd think.
I'd say so. BT, this is a big kick out. They have to stop Fletcher. He's going to go down the middle. Bell Chambers is calling for it.
2:26. The Bomber runner has just gone out. Players will be aware of the time. Maloney bangs it back inside 50. Here's Garland again. Where has this man come from?
Well, he deserves credit. Mark Neal, he moved Colin Garland forward, and he has been a match winner in this last quarter, lining up for his third.
See him then saying to Green, he wanted to go on Green, and he's just saying settle, just calm down, we've got this under control.
What a Wayne Carey about Colin Garland at the moment. It's been sensational. James Heard composed but burning on the inside.
This to make it incredibly hard for the Bombers. Garland for his third consecutive goal has missed, but there is the valuable point. A goal up Melbourne. I don't think they can lose it from here.
They have to force a turnover here. Melksham. It's one-on-ones everywhere.
A minute 34. Not well off the boot there from Melksham. Love it, Murray. Cramery slipped over. Jones applies the tackle. The Bombers still need to remain composed. There's time to even it up on the scoreboard. Kneeled with instructions at ground level.
Mark Neal trying to push numbers back behind the ball. He wants numbers at the back of this contest so Essendon can't open it up straight from the stoppage.
John now with the ruck work, knocked down Zaharakis, the space now. In the end, good effort by Seller.
That was a big one-on-one win from Seller. That went out the back and you were very nervous. Jetta was lurking and James Seller, replacement late for Frawley, done a very good job.
Can't lose here now, Melbourne, I reckon, with under a minute to play in the game. They lead it by 6 points. Ball in dispute in neutral territory on the wing. And the Bombers are going to have to be clean from here. Wow-wee, what an upset brewing. The bottom against the top. Stanton. The in-form against the out-of-form. Pairs upended. Sylvia in their banging bodies. The man that built Eastlink, Magna, advances it forward. Tapscott.
Well, no, this is a terrific win.
James Hurt's had enough. He's exited the box. I've got to flick one out the back. The Bombers, they'll know that. Mark Neal puts his hand up and says, hang on, let's just defend this last one.
Have not won a game since round 23 last year against Gold Coast, the Melbourne Footy Club.
Sneak. It's probably too hard for the Bombers to get it from coast to coast now, but try and force it behind here.
Melbourne are going to win, Richo.
Melbourne, they're going to win.
Melbourne, Melbourne. Right after Jones, take a bow, Melbourne Football Club tonight. You have fought like no other. This man here, full of emotion. Wonder what's going through his mind right now. He says, thank goodness.
Look at the Bombers.
His first win as a senior coach. Mark Neal is going to love this siren. He throws the headset down. The siren hasn't quite gone yet. But he's celebrating. Unbelievable scenes. Neal, players, fans, going absolutely chaotic here. Melbourne have won their first game of the season by a goal.
Demons have won. Cameron Ling is down there with Jack Watts. Take it away, Ling.
Jack, wow. That must be an amazing relief. What a feeling.
Oh, what a feeling. Bloody hell. We've worked so hard over pre-season. We've had a rough couple of weeks to start off with, but you know, the hard work's going to pay off, so we just got to stick at it.
It was just a hard scrap that everybody kept fighting right to the end. That must give you guys a really great feeling.
Yeah, absolutely. That contested ball, winning those clearances out of the middle is huge these days, and the boys in the middle were fantastic. I mean, rushing in the ruck and Beamer and those guys getting the ball forward. We were just at them all day, so great win.
And a pretty special feeling for the coach, Mark Neild, his first win as an AFL coach.
Geez, you feel for him, don't you? And he's done it tough, but what a great feeling, and he deserves every bit of it. He's so good with the boys, and just stoked to be able to get this win for him, and now looking forward to get a couple more.
Well done, Jack. Great work.
Thanks, Lingy. Thanks.
Jack Watts with Cameron Ling there, and the fans are ecstatic here. 42,987 to see Melbourne with their first win of the year.
It's what we love about our game, BT, is that the miracle can happen. The bottom side has been down and out, hasn't been able to get the job done, can come up against a team that is in red-hot form and pull off a miracle. Let's get back down to Lee. I think he's got one of the co-captains with him.
I've got Jack Grimes here, mate. As a captain, you must be very proud of the boys' effort there.
Oh, yeah, we really fought it out towards the end. It was a contested footy, a bit slippery. We really just wanted the four-quarter effort from the boys, and we delivered. It's a great feeling.
And against the quality side too, Essendon have been on fire all year. It must be a great feeling to beat the Bombers, good quality team.
Oh, definitely. We knew they wanted to play that really quick brand of footy, and we sort of wanted to keep it in close and play that contested game. So we feel like we did that, and great to get a win.
You mentioned that it was Mark Neild's first win as an AFL coach, but also yours and Jack Tringo's first win in the AFL as captains. That's a pretty special feeling.
It is pretty special. A bit of a sigh of relief, I think, for Neildy. He's been through a lot, so it's a good feeling, but we still know we've got a long way to go as well. So we'll celebrate this, but we've got a lot of work to do still.
Right on, mate. Go and enjoy yourself.
That's all.
Look at the Melbourne fans hanging over the perimeter piping. They are in love with their outfit and what they've achieved tonight. 7 lead changes in the game. Scores were level on 3 occasions. And they've won by a goal.
Great celebration. Fantastic scenes for the loyal supporters that have turned out tonight. No real expectation from anyone that this was going to happen. And they've been able to come in, persevere. Their coach, Mark Neild, has faced a set of circumstances that almost unique for a first-up coach. The game is great. You're never, ever as bad as it seems, and you're never as good as it seems as well, the Bombers. They go away from this with a little bit of a reassessment at the halfway mark of the year, and we love this about AFL football. Melbourne supporters, congratulations to you. The Twitter world in meltdown here, BT. We are getting a lot of independent supporters. Well done, Melbourne. Congratulations, Mark Neild. Timmy Bone has retweeted again that one.
Yeah, this one here from Matty A. Not a D's fan, but Melbourne really deserved this win. Well done, boys.
Damo Chan let go on the D's. It's still a grand old flag. It's a proud club, the oldest club in the AFL/VFL, who have had a lot of heartache for a long while. Just a little glimmer tonight of perhaps some light at the end of the tunnel.
We are going to go down into the rooms, and boy, are the Demons fans going to enjoy what they hear and see once they form that circle. First win as a captain, co-captain for that man, Tringo. Seller played tonight, got a late call up, and he was very, very impressive. Garland went forward and kicked goals in the last quarter. Sylvia back into the side.
How about the raw emotion from Mark Neild on the siren? He was just containing it, and then he said, you know what? I've had duress. There he is. He's got a smile on his face. Don McClarty, the president, comes down and gives him a big bear hug. That's what the game is all about.
Have a look at the team around him. Look at the support around him saying, OK, this is us as a group. And he's making sure he's involving the whole group. And the scenes that you are about to see as this mob go into the room. Stay with us, because this is going to be exciting as they go down and celebrate within the four walls.
With the people. Just about the only thing you miss in football, BT. When you have a win against the odds in the MCG, when everyone's been kicking you, and you walk in, you're surrounded by 21 mates that you go to battle with each week. That sense of joy now, you can't really explain just how good a feeling that is. James Magner, we love him.
Bill Eastlink by himself.
Not keen to go back there and do it again. Yeah. He's enjoying AFL football, and he enjoyed a lot more tonight with a win. They deserve to celebrate hard, the Demons. We're copping it from everywhere. This is going to be a great rendition of the grand old flag coming up.
Yeah, boy. Congratulations left, right and centre. Don McLarty, the president of the Melbourne Football Club. All of the officials standing back and letting the players that played tonight enjoy this moment. In the middle, they say, for those that haven't experienced the win.
And get out, photographer.
Out, he said. Get out, says Jones. Competition 8-10-58 to the Bombers 6-16-52.
This has been a Fox Footy presentation for Fox Sports.